In college?
Thought I had some good-looking feet about then. That was, you know, about 20 years ago.
What happened? How'd you get all mangled?
It's not there like that bad. I mean, I back then, that was the height of my foot beauty.
Your home of the Gamecocks in Columbia, 107.5, The Game.
The theme of this show. I don't know what happened.
Also heard on 100.3, The Game in Myrtle Beach, and 100.5, The Game in Florence.
This Gamecock team is just built different. They defeat Arkansas 80-66. They tie the school record for wins in a season with 26 victories against only 6 losses, and they will advance to the quarterfinals of the SEC tournament tomorrow afternoon to face the Auburn Tigers.
That was the call yesterday, as Arkansas could not get off the floor fast enough with about 6 minutes to go. Preston Thorne. Arkansas looked like a team. Eric Musselman, I was pretty sure he was going to get a technical to just not have to wait out a second technical to not have to wait out the rest of the game. South Carolina does what we've become South Carolina accustomed to doing. Just kind of strangle the life out of you. Close game at half, and then they just kind of play defense. Delon Cooper's making fadeaway jumpers in the lane. And the next thing you know, we got a Friday game. A no-lose Friday game. I love a no-lose Friday game because go play Auburn. And if you win, oh, boy, lots of excitement. If you lose, come on home. You did your job in the SEC tournament to me.
Validated?
Validated.
Are we validated?
I feel great. I really do. I love it. I feel validated. You're right.
That was the word we kept talking about. That's the word we mentioned about what the win would mean to the season. And you said one of my words. We got strangled. I was also thinking boa constrictor. Just squeeze the life out of somebody until they just tap out, because that's what the game looked like towards the end of the game. It was just Arkansas was just like, all right, man, enough. Okay. Y'all you got it.
Okay. Yeah, all settle right. down. Yes, stop. Please. It's the practice thing where you said you got the young guy who's the hungry pup.
Yes. It's like, please. I know. Okay. Yes. I know you're please relax. And it just looked like they just strangled the life out of them. And by the end of the game, Arkansas, they were ready to go home. And that's a really beautiful brand of basketball to watch, especially when it's your team.
Mm-hmm.
When it's your team, it's like, oh, man, this is coming. I see the footprints of what's about to happen. So, yeah, really fun game to watch. I was watching it at an establishment yesterday.
Okay.
Which is really cool because guess what? People in this town care.
Right now they love it.
People care, man. I mean, people were locked in watching the game. But it wasn't like the nervous energy of watching the game. People were just cheering along. Really cool atmosphere. So people in this town are excited right now.
That you're exactly right. This town is on fire with college basketball. Obviously, what Dawn Staley's doing, what Lamont Paris is doing. And that's the other news. We'll get more into the South Carolina Arkansas game. A couple of numbers from yesterday that instantly jumped out. But that's the other news is – we don't know the value just yet. I've seen multiple numbers between 3.5 and 4 for Lamont Paris, but according to all reports, there will be a board of trustees meeting later this morning, and at that point, we'll get the full details. But it appears South Carolina has locked in Lamont Paris for the foreseeable future. The numbers coming out right now are 6 years. ESPN is reporting around $4 million a year. It's a significant pay raise. You and I were laughing about the first time you look in the bank account and you see a $1 million pay raise a year. Almost a $1.8 million pay raise is going to be an interesting thought when you look in the first check in the bank account.
I tell you, Lamont's going to feel this one. It's going to hit that first, whatever the fiscal year starts and his direct deposits start re-upping, whatever that Tuesday is, he's going to be like, woo, okay. He's going to have a little different feeling.
He's going to have
I can use that gourmet cheese in the mac and cheese.
That's exactly what I was going to say. The cheese in the mac and cheese is going to change a little bit.
We got to have 6 cheeses this week, not 5. 6 cheeses this week. It's on me.
I'm interested to see the numbers. I'm all for it. I'm not footing the bill, so I can only ask what's financially responsible. This is an inch. If it is indeed, and again, there have been multiple reports that it's around $4 million. Nothing confirmed. It does appear a six-year extension is confirmed. That'll also lend us to what is the buyout potentially? What is the buyout for another program to try and keep him? There's going to be the small little things there about these contracts that is going to be really interesting later today when we get all the details.
Yeah, the numbers are going to be, like you said, interesting, because as I'm even looking at the words, the numbers, 2030, what is that, the future? Where are we?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? We're looking at, you know, we talk about 2030. Who, I mean, it's ridiculous that we even say, I'm sure most of us, when we say 2024, it's like, what? But then you say 2030, that's a really long ways away. So who knows what's going to happen in between now and then. But it is nice to see that the sides have come to an agreement and there's a little bit, that particular distraction is taken off the table for right now.
I will say that there is a perception. Now, Frank Martin had, he had a reputation and he was a well-known basketball coach. But when I was doing scouting and I'd be in those hospitality and VIP rooms with other coaches, there was a perception South Carolina doesn't pay for men's basketball coaches. And this is, I will say this, even if you feel like it might be overpaid, this is a situation where you break that mold. You break that trend and people go, oh, South Carolina seems to really care. Look at what they're doing. That will resonate. That will reverberate throughout the college basketball world. Just was, oh, okay, that's a place that, if I want to go, they'll be willing to pay me. This is a little bit bigger than just Lamont Paris. This is going to be something I think shows South Carolina is willing to make a serious commitment to its men's basketball program.
Well, again, judging by the establishment that I was in yesterday, people are excited. And so if you're having a chance to invest and double down on something that is working and you get it at the front end, that's probably something you have to do. And again, these are all good problems to have, because the alternative to this is we could be talking about coaching searches, as we might get into a little bit later.
Heck is a
hot seat. Yeah. Hot seats, coaching searches, a lot of things are happening. So to have the good side of these problems is a very nice spot for us to be in.
And it is a great way to capitalize on what is maybe the most momentum I've seen South Carolina basketball have in 30 years, almost since those 90s Eddie Fogler runs, because you see what they've done this season. You see the energy and excitement. The fan base is fully engaged and recruiting is going well. Recruiting is and not only that, the more and more and more, and again, we'll get into this game a little bit, the more and more and more I watch Zach Davis, I'm like, oh, young pup's biting. He's growing right in front of our eyes. And yesterday, Zach Davis, it felt like Lamont Paris and he had a talk on the flight up to, this had kind of been building, but it felt like yesterday there had been a talk on the way up to Nashville, like, hey, young buck, you can shoot threes, we'll allow it, but you're at your best going to the rim and doing something.
You better be wide open. You better be, the ball has to have swung around two times and you need to be wide open to take the, Zach, do you understand? Yes, sir. No, Zach, look at me. Do you understand? Yes, sir. Okay, go play.
Well, we'll get into that. That young pup is starting to bite. Yes. And he is, and he knows his role, because he only scored 8 yesterday, but it was a kind of an impressive 8. But he's looking around going, I understand, my time's coming next year. That foundation with he and Colin Murray Boyles, and you add a few more pieces, that it's exciting times. It is. This is, as I said, this might be the most momentum I've ever seen for South Carolina men's basketball. And kudos to Chance Miller and Ray Tanner for striking while the iron is hot, if you will, and doing that. We'll hit the flip side of it as well. Lamont Paris, it was a huge day for him financially. Mike Boynton, Jerry Stackhouse, some other people, not so much, as you mentioned, with coaching searches. We'll get into a lot of that this morning. South Carolina baseball has a series coming up as well. We'll get into that. A lot to do this morning. And, of course, we got to get you ready. A whole nother game later this afternoon against the Auburn Tigers, a revenge game, and I'll say it again, a no-lose game. South Carolina, whatever happens, they've secured their seed in the NCAA tournament. So we'll get into that a little bit. 803-404-6100. Let's get out to the Love Chevy phone lines. Gamecock Larry wants to weigh in this morning. Gamecock Larry, how are you?
Good morning, everybody. Gamecock Nation, get ready. Get behind this Gamecock basketball team, because old Gamecock Larry may not be around, but I guarantee you, take it to the bank. We're going to have double champions in about, if we don't have them this year, you will have them next year, because Lamont knows how to coach, he knows how to recruit, and he knows how to hit the transfer portal. But it's going to take some money to keep these young men there. So get ready. Game double champions in basketball and men's basketball. And this year we might even have a men's baseball team in the NCAA. Old Gamecock, remember the Frank McGuire days. Old man McGuire came in, now young man Lamont comes in, and he's going to take us in places that haven't been in a while. And let's see what else. Oh, yeah, Root Hog, what you got to say about now? What you got to say, Root Hog? Oh, my God, all that old Rick and Rad you talking about. And I'm going to say something right now to go shake you in your boots, Root Hog. Gamecock by 7 over Auburn today. I don't know what the score is going to be, but I guarantee you it won't be no 100 or something. It'll be a whole lot less than that. That's all I got to say. Gamecock Nation, everybody, get behind this team. 107.5. I love all y'all. Have a good weekend. Gamecock, let's go. Enjoy the basketball. Up to, let's see, we should be national. Yeah, we'd be in the national championship. Oh, no, not SEC championship. Sunday, is that right? Sunday. Gamecock Larry going to call you Monday, and he's going to have a lot to crow about. Go Gamecocks. Love all y'all. Talk to you later.
There you go. 6:12 on your Friday morning, March the 15th, Preston Thorne. We are halfway through March. I know. Unbelievable that we are moving at this rate of speed. We'll get you ready. We'll look back. Yesterday's game, we talked a little bit about Zach Davis, a couple other numbers that jumped out and why it was an even more impressive victory for South Carolina than just rolling over Arkansas 80-66. You're listening to Preston Thorne, Bill Gunner, she's Jen Jensen, Friday morning edition of The Early Game.
The Game Network.
The home of the Gamecocks. 107.5, The Game in Columbia. 100.5, The Game in Florence. 100.3, The Game in Myrtle Beach.
Also on the 107.5, The Game app. And streaming live on The Game TV. Download the 107.5, The Game app and listen anywhere. The beach. The gym. And yes, even there. Go to iTunes or Google Play and snag the 107.5 The Game app. 107.5 The Game. Broadcasting live from the Herndon Chevrolet Studios.
Discover Herndon Certified. Herndon Chevrolet's premier used car warranty. Shop with complete confidence knowing Herndon Chevrolet has got you covered.
Stop by or shop online today.
Attention business owners. Tired of parking headaches in your business lot? Get a fresh start with Shredder's Towing. Call Shredder's Towing and receive free custom signage, high-quality, eye-catching deterrence for unwanted parking. Call Shredder's Towing, your partner for stress-free, clear lot in 2024. They have over 1,300 reviews and a near 5-star rating backing up their work. Because this year, it's all about a fresh start and a clear lot with Shredder's Towing.
Shredder's Towing, the best and fastest hookers in town.
Plus tax and title with proof credit, call 888-320-6359 for details.
JT is throwing a party this weekend for Kia Mania. JT's giving away a new Kia Saturday 5 p.m. at both the Greystone and Killian Road locations. So come on out. Plus there's food, fun, and games for the kids Saturday and Sunday. Everyone who comes can spin our prize wheel for cash and prizes. JT is loaded with new 2024 Kia Souls, Sportages, and Fortes. Zero down, zero payments for 6 months. JT gives a huge cash back check. With every new Kia, JT's Kia Mania is back.
At the Samuels Reynolds Law Firm, we know how serious injuries change people's lives. I'm Jason Reynolds. When you're involved in a major car or truck accident, my team is on your side. You don't have to be alone. Let's do this together.
And I'm Steven Samuels. When you're hurt at work, my team is with you from start to finish. We're people with a passion for helping injured workers. Bring your case to us and stop the worry. We've got this.
Samuels Reynolds. True injuries, true lawyers. 803-779-4000.
The Midland's Best St. Paddy's Festival is happening at O'Hara's Public House in Lexington, and you're cordially invited to share in the celebration March 16th and 17th. St. Paddy's Day weekend starts at O'Hara's Bakery at 8 a.m. both Saturday and Sunday, with kegs and eggs at the pub starting at 9. Food and drink specials are happening all day, both inside the pub and outside under the party tent. Make sure you get in for your serving of corned beef and cabbage or any of the traditional Irish favorites available year-round at O'Hara's Public House. Starting at 3 p.m. on Sunday, come out to enjoy two of Columbia's favorite musical acts as they come together to rock the outside stage under the big top with Prettier Than Matt and Tokyo Joe. That's Saturday and Sunday, the 16th and 17th at O'Hara's Pub and Bakery. It's our sweet deal of the week. Get $50 towards your next visit to O'Hara's Public House for just $25. This Friday at 9 a.m., log on to 1075thegame.com and click on Sweet Deals to get your $50 to O'Hara's Public House for just $25. Celebrate St. Patrick's Day with Irish beer, special food, and live Celtic music this Saturday, March 16th at Savage Craft Ale Works. Welcome back pints of gold and a wee bit of wit, brewed specifically for this annual event. They can even make it green for you. The Bogarts duo return for their third year with all your Irish favorites to set the stage for the Steel City Rovers. Admission and parking are free. Limited edition St. Paddy's Day logo t-shirts are available now and will sell out before Saturday. Pick yours up today. See you at Savage, 430 Center Street, West Columbia, this Saturday.
Must be 21 with valid ID to drink. Please celebrate responsibly.
Get out to Charwood Golf.
Only one accident out there, and that's good news. We hope that clears up quickly. I-77 northbound at I-20. All else moving along fairly well throughout the Midlands, and we're looking for high today of 80. Might see some afternoon or evening thunderstorms. Tomorrow, a mix of clouds and sun, 78 for the high. 73 on Sunday with just some kind of cloudy conditions. Monday, we cool down a little bit to 66, 59 on Tuesday. But right now, it's 54 on the early game.
The early game with Bill Gunter.
Former Gamecock Preston Thorne.
And Jen Jensen. Your home of the Gamecocks in Columbia. 107.5 The Game.
Also heard on 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach. And 100.5 The Game in Florence.
'80-66. That was the score yesterday as Lamont Paris and South Carolina pick up the victory in Nashville, something that actually had not occurred in quite some time. Preston Thorne, it had surprisingly been a while. South Carolina has been on for all the, and Frank Martin did a lot of really good things. For all the really good things Frank Martin did, success in the SEC tournament, it was almost non-existent. He just couldn't get it done. South Carolina hasn't been to the weekend, and I don't know how long. It might have been Trey Kelly's year. It's been a very long time since South Carolina made it all the way to the weekend. And just getting a victory in the SEC was in the SEC tournament was a very nice step forward. To do it as you said, in dominant fashion, where you're not having the nervous second half energy, that was even better.
They just pulled away from them very, very systemically, very systematically, very logistically. They just, okay, we're just going to push the gas a little bit here and you're going to pull away from you. And it was no, didn't feel like it was a struggle. They got more crisp on offense as the time went along. They threw the little funky new defense on them. It's fun to be on this side. This has been my overall theory of basketball. This has been fun. It's fun to be on a team, this type of team.
We've said it. Enjoy this ride. Enjoy these next 2 weeks. And one of the things about yesterday was amazing is they do it without the three-point shot. Just 3 of 15 yesterday. B.J. Mack hitting 2 of those 3 three-pointers. Miles Studi hitting the third. It was a dominant performance in the paint. And Colin Murray Boyles, now that I've watched him for a season, I'm trying to figure out how to describe him, because yesterday, just, you know, left-handed over the shoulder hook shot, right-handed over the whole over the shoulder hook shot.
YMCA.
Just
all time at the YMCA. Hall of Famer YMCA game. It's like you said, little flip.
Just
saw one time he hit a, which was amazingly athletic because he's lefty, correct?
Right.
And he hit a right-handed bank shot fading away, which was like, that was very impressive. But yes, his game is very, very Tim Duncan-esque.
He has a level of athleticism that I don't, when you see him, I don't think you think it's there, but then he goes up and hammers one home. But you're right. It's, you know, get it about 12 feet out, dribble into the middle, just kind of a little, you know, maybe a stop, good pivot, reverse, opposite hand layup. Very.
This team leads the SEC in pivot foot. We are going to be
and on square downs.
We're going to be on our pivot foot and square down. We are going to do that 100%.
Fundamentally, you're right. 18 assists yesterday. Actually led, again, by Zach Davis. 4 assists yesterday for that young fella.
One of those, I don't know the technical term, maybe it was like a pin down or something along the line. He comes off, bounce passes, one-hand bounce pass to CMB for the dunk. And it looked so simple, but the pass, the execution was amazing.
Zach Davis, if you just like looked at the points and the numbers, you'd be like, 4, 7, 8 points. Well, what are you kind of referencing? He filled the stat sheet. 8 points yesterday, 4 assists, 2 steals. Even got in on the turnover game. 2 of those, fouled somebody 3 times. Had 2 rebounds. Took a couple free throws. Didn't make those. 1 three-pointer, which is what we kind of pointed to. Lamont Paris might have been, hey, young fella, I know that 3-pointer looks tantalizing, but how about you think about, because he attacked the rim. And if he's willing to do that, it will open up other parts of his game. And then, of course, he's such a force of nature when they go to that 1-3-1 on defense. And other teams right now can't figure it out. It's amazing because I've been aware of a 1-3-1 for over 20 years. Played it a little bit in high school. I've got it. And now I'm watching these colleges, and that 1-3-1 comes out. It's like, whoa! You know, Arkansas, this happened to Arkansas. It's happened to other teams.
Well, this gets to be the thing where, in football terms, you know, you put something on tape. Now teams are having to take some of their precious time and have to go over, okay, guys, you remember the 1-3-1? You probably went against it when you was sixth grade AAU ball. Let's remember how to swing the ball around. And everybody, yeah, whatever. And then it comes out in real life. And it's been an effective changeup defensively for the team.
It's because yesterday it basically stopped Arkansas cold in their track. They didn't know how to get the ball down into the corner. There was one turnover where one Arkansas player was kind of standing on the block. One was in the corner, and they threw it between both of them. And the guy on the block looked at the guy in the corner like
it just sailed out of bounds.
Yeah.
I don't know the basketball technical terms. You could help me out, or if any of our basketball folks are listening. But it felt like maybe the word is extended. Felt like they extended.
They do. They come out. They push you out. They keep you from getting. The way that works with basketball is to extend you out so that shot clock runs down. So all of a sudden you get into 12, about the 12-second range. And now you're kind of rushing to get your shot. It's kind of why some teams will press with the 35-second shot clock, and it's not so much to force a turnover. It's maybe to eat up 6 or 7 seconds, maybe 8 gotcha. Seconds. So now you come down, you've gone from 35 to 27. Now you're trying to get in your offense, and if you can slow them down another 7 seconds, Now you've only got 20 seconds to operate, and it really can throw you off. And that 1-3-1 gets that ball out top and extends you out. They're not in shooting range the majority of the time when they catch and squirt. So now you're having to take a second to figure it out, to work the ball around a little bit more. Now you cut down what was a 35-second shot clock, or if you get it across at around 28, 7 seconds, you've cut it down to maybe 16 or 15. And now teams, that's only about enough time to run one play, and then you go into a one-on-one ISO mode.
That makes sense. Bill, did you just get basketball hands?
Basketball handsy, yeah.
Little basketball hands.
Yeah, you love doing that.
Yeah, I don't know the technical term, but I could just see what was happening. It was just pushing them out there. And then you said with Zach Davis being so long at the top of it, you have to try and make an effort to throw the ball around them.
You can't be lazy with it.
Very, absolutely.
Another stat yesterday, and this is what the announcers kept talking about, 12 offensive rebounds from South Carolina. South Carolina out-rebounds Arkansas 33-26 yesterday. But the big part of that, the domination on the interior. And that was the part. South Carolina, again, if you'd normally tell me going into the game, South Carolina's going to be 3 of 15 from three-point range, I'm like, whoa, I'd probably side with the other team in this scenario. South Carolina completely, and a lot of it, Colin Murray Boyles yesterday, 11 of 15, 24 points. B.J. Mack had 19. The interior guys for South Carolina dominated the game. That was still a bit of a shock to me.
So it looks like they had 52 points in the paint.
Yes.
And I'm sure Arkansas was not very happy about that. But you're right. This team, who at different points in the season has relied on different ways to score and different ways to win games. For a while, they were a three-ball team. Now it looks like they're a perimeter team. It seems as if you put those things together, it makes them a tough team to play against.
They are. I mean, this team fundamentally, and you know this, when you were talking about yesterday with Lamont Paris, this team looks confident. They don't look like a team who has this ton of like annoying swag. They don't come out where they're like, they are just like the old men at the YMCA who comes out and is like, I know how good I am. I know my game. I'm going to play my game, and I'm going to beat you. Like,
well, yeah, I saw a quote from Talon Cooper. And basically he said his idea was, we are a defensive team. So they have their identity set in stone. They know who and what they are. They understand that when they watch maybe some of these other teams that are high flying and throwing the ball around, that's not what they do. But having a team identity makes it much easier to play to that identity, and especially when we get into tournament time and the games are going to get tight. They can lean on, we're a defensive team. We can get a stop here, because they're going to need a stop at some point. If whether it's today or in the NCAA, and they have that cachet built up that they know they can get those stops.
Yeah, I mean, they're playing exceptionally well. Again, a lot of confidence right now from them as with the way they play, with the way they perform. And again, it'll be about 3:30. Yesterday's early game moved pretty quick. Tennessee today and Mississippi State will be the 1 o'clock game. And at 3:30, you'll have South Carolina and Auburn set to go there again in what I call a no-lose situation for the Gamecocks. We'll talk a little bit about that. 803-404-6100. All right, well, now it really, the heat turns up on Lamont Paris. Looks like you're going to get the contract. You're going to be paid, young fella. Extra cheese in the mac and cheese. All the good noodles. You can buy the fancy noodles. We'll talk about Lamont Paris and this contract as we roll along. 803-404-6100. You're listening to The Early Game.
The Game Network.
The home of the Gamecocks. 107.5, The Game in Columbia. 100.5, The Game in Florence. 100.3, The Game in Myrtle Beach.
Also on the 107.5, The Game app. And streaming live on The Game TV.
Listen to Gamecocks baseball on The Game. And if a Gamecocks batter hits a grand slam,
you could win cash. You could win cash.
You could win cash.
You could win cash in the Palmetto Citizens Federal Credit Union Grand Slam Giveaway. Go to 1075thegame.com and register. Brought to you by Palmetto Citizens Federal Credit Union and The Game.
Preston here for Absolute Glass, the premier glass company of the Midlands, offering auto, home, and business glass repair. So if your glass is damaged, shattered, cracked, or broken, they can handle the job. If it's a cracked windshield, that's no problem. They'll come out to your location and replace it for you. Yes, they will come to you wherever you are, whether you're at school, home, work, doesn't matter. Absolute Glass will come out to your location, take care of it for you, usually for free, and they'll work directly with your insurance to take away the headache. Now, if you're sitting at home and looking to increase the value of your home with new windows or mirrors, Absolute Glass will come out and take care of that for you too. Windows, mirrors, shower enclosures. You hear me say it all the time. If you can see through it, Ray and Mariana, Absolute Glass can do it. So check them out online at AbsoluteGlassInc.com. That's online at AbsoluteGlassInc.com.
At George Sink Injury Lawyers, they've been advocating for your rights for over 40 years. Injured? Let them fight for the money you deserve. Call them at 888-999-9999. Office in 1440 Broad River Road, Columbia, South Carolina. Case results vary and are not guaranteed. No fees, no recovery.
On the baseline, shoots it up over Vanover. Got it!
I take a lot of pride in being from South Carolina. It's part of why I chose the school. I just wanted them to know, man, I got love for this school. I think the school loves me as well. And just a guy that gave it his all while he was here and just made continuous improvement and just a winner, man. A guy that really wanted to win and left it all on the court every time.
Everyone says they care about the team and they care about winning, but, you know, I think this group especially is all about winning.
When I'm in the huddle with my teammates, when we're on the road, when we're going up against somebody, I just always tell them, be us. Be who we are. Don't try to be nobody else. Like, you can look at it and be like, well, doing something right now. You know what I'm saying? We just want to stay on that path. You know, stay on that path to greatness and stay on that path to Mark.
And see what diamonds are selling for online, and then come see us. You'll get exactly what you want at the very best price. Only at Traditions Fine Jewelers, 5134 Sunset Boulevard in Lexington, and in Sand Hills, where the Midlands get engaged.
Pete Alewine Pool and Spa is getting you ready for pool season with their March Mayhem Sale. Saturday, March 16th through Saturday, March 23rd. 20% off all pool and spa chemicals to get your pool swim ready. 20% off salt, 20% off chlorine, 20% off algicides, 20% off shock, and more. March Mayhem at Pete Alewine Pool and Spa, March 16th through March 23rd. They're located at 5541 Sunset Boulevard. You'll find them on Facebook and Instagram or online at PeteAlewinePools.com.
Music fans, on Friday, March 22nd, a very special night is coming to Columbia. Southern Songwriters with Patrick Davis, a national television show produced for SCE-TV and American Public Television, is taping live at the historic Chappelle Auditorium at Allen University. Patrick will be joined by Drew Holcomb, David Ryan Harris, and Sean Mullins. This show will air on more than 300 stations this summer, and you can be part of it. Tickets are on sale at SouthernSongwriters.com or PatrickDavisMusic.com. One night only, March 22nd in Columbia.
The Game On Demand podcast menu.
Sponsored by Lexington Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
If you're dealing with injuries or pain, our team is here to get you better sooner.
107.5 The Game. 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach. 100.5 The Game in Florence.
WIST-TV First Alert Traffic is sponsored by Wetzel's Automotive in West Columbia. Wetzelsauto.com.
I-20 westbound between Monticello Road and Broad River Roads. That'd be between exits 68 and 65. There is an accident. So just giving you a heads up on that. Also, I-77 northbound at I-20. And forecast-wise, not too bad. The rain chances are definitely down from what they had been. We could see some afternoon or evening showers and thunderstorms today, tonight, or this afternoon or this evening. A high of 80, 78 tomorrow, 73 on Sunday, dropping to 66 on Monday. But right now, it's fair, and it's 54 on the early game.
What
you're talking about. Sponsored by Love Chevrolet.
On your home of the Gamecocks in Columbia, 107.5 The Game.
Also heard on 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach and 100.5 The Game in Florence.
How you can weigh in. A reminder coming up April the 5th, Friday, April the 5th. Come out and join Preston, myself, Jen, of course, and the whole 107.5 The Game gang as we are having our annual spring golf tournament at Charwood Golf Club. 10 a.m. shotgun start, $400 per team. Call today and get yourself registered. 803-755-2000. Again, it's 803-755-2000 to get registered. When you're out there, you can have a chance to win a pair of tickets to each Gamecock baseball game for the remainder of the season. That's just one of the great raffles we will be giving away. We'll have breakfast, we'll have lunch, we'll have a whole bunch of things. So go ahead, get signed up. Call Charwood today, 803-755-2000. Get signed up. It is our annual spring golf tournament coming up Friday, April the 5th at Charwood Golf Club, 10 a.m. shotgun start. Again, $400 per foursome. So go ahead and call Charwood today. That's how you can get registered, 803-755-2000. So South Carolina, Preston Thorne has elected to have Lamont Paris, rightfully so, lead this program moving forward. And yesterday, Lamont talked a little bit about the confidence or the feeling in having being told that he is going to lead the team. Jen, as I'm looking at Wednesday's cut list. I should go back to Friday's cut list. It's number 14. The school trusting Lamont Paris for him to continue to lead the program. We'll talk about this contract extension. This is Lamont Paris yesterday talking about he and the school now working together on this extension.
I've got a lot of pride in what we've done.
Sorry, I was very confused.
And what we've built. And so I'm incredibly excited about being able to be the coach and represent this university and this athletic department, and more specifically this basketball team. It's a real thrill for me to be able to coach these guys. I love where I am, and they like me too. So what else was there to do but to make a good deal? So, I'm really fortunate and blessed that one, I get to do this as a profession. I get to hang around guys like the two guys that were out here and have some sort of small impact on what their college experience is going to turn out to be. And I take a lot of pride in that. And I'm even more blessed to be able to do it at this institution and around the people and in the state that I am. So I'm really excited, really, really excited about moving forward. And this was a no-brainer, at least on my part. I mean, I think we had to nudge Coach Tanner a little bit, maybe. No, I'm just kidding. But it's such a great match. Just me, the fit, the community, the other coaches, and I'm very grateful. I'm grateful to our board, to Ray Tanner, to our president, and hopefully that we can continue to grow for a long time. Okay.
Let me say this, because as I watched yesterday's game, and there's Dawn Staley sitting there supporting Lamont Paris, and we've seen Lamont support him. I think Lamont has also seen how Dawn Staley has been embraced by this community. What Dawn Staley has built. I mean, let's be honest. South Carolina women's basketball was nothing before Dawn Staley. It was a nice year here, a nice year there, but it was nothing. Dawn Staley has built that. And in a lot of ways, the men's basketball program is very similar.
There is some resemblance to that. And again, you saw Dawn obviously out there supporting. She's out there talking with Ray Tanner. Everybody looks like a happy family. That's not to be taken for granted, because there's a lot of places where people are seeing the AD and they're going in the other room, right? You know, I see him coming down the hall and we both like, oh boy, here we go. So there is some synergy and positive feelings that are happening. Much credit to Dawn, because you remember they were coming off the coming off the national championship, she brings Lamont on stage amongst the parade and is like, hey, get behind this guy. And she's putting him up there like, this is a guy that we should support. She did not have to do that.
Right.
Right. And so he has been embraced by the rightful queen of basketball in the city, and he's ascending to a spot where people are starting to embrace him also.
And again, I think he sees the reputation she now has in this community, what she has become. South Carolina, I mean, look, this is a basketball community. It's just needing that spark. It needs that guy and his personality. He talked about fit, Preston Thorne. And I think that's a great description of Lamont Paris in South Carolina right now. The university, the fan base, everything. It feels like a great fit. Now, how does it look going forward? He's going to have to find, I think the biggest concern I have going forward for just next year is finding a point guard. I don't know if we give Talon Cooper the amount of credit that he truly deserves. I've kind of been starting to beat this drum the last few weeks for the way Talon Cooper's played. But as I said, there are pieces in place, and there are guys who are eligible to come back, Nietzsche Johnson and Miles Studi, to go along with Colin Murray-Boyles and with Zach Davis.
And when you say fit, it's really interesting because I heard multiple comments of like, man, he's so cool. Look how relaxed he is on the sideline. And it's really interesting to watch. Obviously, that's a just position with our previous coach, and that can work too. But I do think in South Carolina, a kinder, gentler state, we kind of like that easygoing confidence. That
you kind of need to know your audience, so to speak.
He kind of matches with the temperament of the way this state sort of operates. And so it really does fit with everything that works within this city. I think Lamont is very easily digestible. He obviously knows what he's talking about. I think it's something that a lot of people can get behind. But first, he's winning. And then, because obviously, if the things weren't going right, you'd be saying, oh man, he's too cool on the sideline. Why is he, you know, saying so? It all starts with winning the games.
803-404-6100. Let's get out to the Love Chevy phone line. Jeff wants to weigh in this morning on the basketball program. Jeff, how you doing? What's on your mind?
What's going on, guys? I got a question for you. So when CMB came in, one of his top things was his shooting in 3-point. Are we waiting to see this? Is it something secret?
That's a great question. Appreciate you calling. Everything I've read is that was something that he came into the season with, is that he had a nice touch from the outside. And to be quite frank, that's something he's going to have to continue to develop for the next level when he starts to get ready for future in the NBA. But I don't know whether that's just because it doesn't fit into the scheme that they're running or what the case is, but that is interesting. We have not really seen that part of the game.
That's not his strength is within 10 to 12 feet. Just in talking with people that were out in Utah that knew him, that was not something that was brought up. They said, now, can he do it? Yes, there's a difference, but it still has to be developed more so.
And so that, to that point, when you think about development, maybe that's a guy that stays around for another year or 2 years and develops that outside shot to his game. And then we, as a fan, we get to see that aspect. He's going to have to – I'm not trying to get too far ahead now, but in order for him to be successful and they may at his size, he's going to have to develop an outside shot.
He's a bigger kid than the guy I'm going to reference. But if he can – because he's more skilled. He's a better basketball player than Michael Carrera was. But remember how Carrera came in and initially was an interior guy, and then by his senior year, they had moved him to where he was able to step out on the perimeter and consistently knock down a shot and even handle the ball some. And Colin Murray-Boyles is a better basketball. He is already sitting with a better skill set right now, and it's not just relying off of hustle and the things Carrera did to get under the skin of the other team. Murray-Boyles is a better player. That will come in time. I mean, you look at it again right now for the season and what he's doing. He's shooting 68% from the foul line. That's got to improve a little bit for him. He's 62%. He's an efficient shooter. He's a very efficient shooter, but that's because a lot of it's the work around the rim, and he's a crafty player, smart player. We said YMCA earlier. He's got a lot of things figured out. He has athleticism to go with it. That'll come, but he does need to develop that a little bit more. 803-404-6100. We'll come back. We'll wrap up. Hour number one, you're listening to The Early Game.
The Game Network.
The home of the
Gamecocks. 107.5, The Game in Columbia. 100.5, The Game in Florence. 100.3, The Game in Myrtle Beach.
Also on the 107.5, The Game app and streaming live on The Game TV. Powered by Integrated Media, The Game TV.
Sponsored by Shepherd's Glass, a true reflection of quality.
The Game TV.
Punxsutawney Phil has an overall accuracy rating of 36% nationally. This was in 2021, 36% nationally. Now, those numbers can get skewed a little bit because in the Northeast, it tends to be colder for longer. But when you extrapolate his numbers out for the rest of the regions in the Southwest, the Southeast, Punxsutawney Phil, the fraud, only gets up to 50% nationally. Only 50%. You're saying, oh, what does that mean? That's still pretty good. It's not. It's not. There are six other rodent prognosticators that are above Punxsutawney Phil. Number one, our guy, General Beauregard Lee. General Beauregard Lee has a 63% accuracy rating nationally, 70% when you extrapolate it for just the South. This guy is crushing Punxsutawney Phil, but yet we still are talking about Punxsutawney Phil. He's a fraud, Bill. He's a fraud. Not only that, Buckeye Chuck. This guy, Buckeye Chuck, is crushing. He's number two. But you know who else is ahead of him? Let me go to my list.
Who exactly is Buckeye Chuck?
Buckeye Chuck is in Ohio, Bill.
Makes sense.
Mm-hmm. Bad. I got you. Thank goodness.
Buckeye Chuck is in Ohio. But let's go to this list. We got Jimmy the Groundhog.
Oh, just Jimmy.
Jimmy the Groundhog. Lander Lil. Stormy the Marmot. Smomish Slough. Finally, after all of those guys, we come down to Punxsutawney Phil. But who gets all the credit? Who gets all the notoriety? Punxsutawney Phil. And it's only because he was there a long, long time ago. He was an originator. I'll give you credit. He was an originator. But the game of guessing and predicting weather has passed him by. He's a fraud. It's overrated. It's time for him to get out the game. Give the throne to General Beauregard Lee. All I'm saying is he's overrated. All of this celebration.
You got to get this live stream. We're watching. Would you describe this?
There's a big celebration on, but you know what about these people? It's not about the game anymore. It's about something else. They have ruined the celebrity prognosticator game for these rodents because these guys are working hard. Buckeye Chuck.
Are they?
He's working. He's accurately predicting things. Beauregard Lee. 70%, and he can't get any love across the South. No love. Everybody talks about Punxsutawney Phil. I'm saying it right now. If Punxsutawney Phil gets this wrong today, get him out of here.
I'm going to go with the odds are not good.
Put him in the garbage. 36%, of course it's not good. It's what he does nationally.
Gamecock Preston Thorne and Jen Jensen.
Your home of the Gamecocks in Columbia. 107.5, The Game. Also heard on 100.
Let me just make really sure that, but I haven't seen any emails.
I have The Game in Florence.
Welcome back into the early game. It's Preston Thorne, Bill Gunner, Jen Jensen. We are back to finish out the hour. We've been having a lot of basketball talk. Big game coming up this afternoon. But to finish off our pro day conversation over the past week, some guys have been getting a lot of attention in the South Carolina uniform. Obviously, Spencer Rattler went out and threw the ball really well. Xavier Leggett went to the combine, ran very fast, came back to the weight room, lifted a bunch of weights, a lot of times. He's hitting the radar of a lot of teams. But apparently Xavier is hitting the radar of the nation, not for his physical prowess, but for his voice, his accent. And I would like to know, what is the more shocking combination here? Is it voice or accent, or is it a beautiful mix of the two? Jen, can we hear our guy Xavier responding to a question?
Man, I'll be right down the road. It'll be a little easier for my family to come watch me play, so that'll be great. That's just them telling me down that they want me on their team, man. A lot of coaches came and hollered at me before and after this process here, man. A lot of them, man, they say they got a buzz in their facility for me, man, and I'm just ready to see where I'm going to land.
You're taking a pitch or catching a short pass or catching a deep ball. What would you say are the best parts of your game that help you get into the end zone so often?
Oh, man, I say the deep ball, man. But I really feel like any way that I get the ball in my hand, I could get it to that end zone.
Not the voice I expected.
Yeah, I think it shocked a lot of people. So I wonder, is it the voice or is it the accent? I think we all here are very familiar with an accent, right?
Right.
I was amazing to watch the internet discover Mullins, South Carolina, and a lot of people saying, oh, okay, that's Mullins, South Carolina, because I believe it was Mullins. There's a town north of Mullins, maybe called Ketchup. And then on the Google map, there's a place where you can go mudding and sanding at the same time, and people were very excited about that.
Wow, and I've gone mudding, but I've not gone sanding.
So that feels very Mullins, and feels like somebody with that accent is very proficient in mudding and sanding.
I wasn't completely ready for this. You know, Donnell Stanley from Latta, similar.
Very similar.
So it's not, and having to do the recruiting that I used to do and travel around, go down there, Dylan's always got some good players, Latta, Mullins in that area. Yeah, it wasn't a complete shock to me, but I can see. Also, the Patrick Mahomes one is the one that always catch you completely off guard, whereas Xavier Leggett, I think I'd heard enough.
Right.
Yeah, I'm not.
Well, I think, and again, I think that's because we're from South Carolina, and if you've traveled parts of this state, you've sort of heard various accents of that, depending, you know, deeper in deeper spots of the place. It sounds different. SC Mike says, yeah, it sounds normal to me. Yeah, somebody's like, really interesting point somebody was bringing up yesterday when they used to talk about King of the Hill and they used to have Boomhauer on there. All of us, the joke was nobody could understand him, but most of us in the South were like, yeah, I get it. I understand everything he's saying. What's the joke? He's making perfect sense to me. So I thought that was really interesting to hear people discover now that's not a normal South Carolina accent. That's a very deep, unique South Carolina accent.
I haven't thought about it. We got two people that weighed in, Monty and another texter who said he sounds a little bit similar to Randy Moss.
Yes. Yes. When Randy Moss is another one. Again, West Virginia. How else would somebody sound if they're from deep West Virginia? That's a very good one.
It's a very good comparison on that. You are right. Xavier Leggett is drawing a lot of attention. But this is the kind of attention where people are like, oh, man, he's got a personality. I like this. Put him in our locker room. Like, it's actually good. I think it's increasing his draft stock. And it has nothing to do with running or jumping or being really good at the game of football.
I might just get a few more eyes on him too, you know, like, oh, what are they talking about? And then they see some of the tape and stuff, and it just a little extra,
yeah,
something.
They see the clips.
Make them a little extra special.
They see the clips. Yeah. That's a very Randy Moss is a good comparison. But I think the rest of the country, and here's what it is. The rest of the country doesn't really expect black people to be from the country. And so they hear a black person with a country accent, they're like, what is that? And it's like, yeah, I mean, that's kind of that's the rest of South Carolina. That's how South Carolina sounds. And so it's just really interesting. And again, Randy Moss from West Virginia, from Rand, West Virginia. That's essentially how that person would sound.
Yeah, the West Virginia and remember he came out with Jason Williams at the same time too, and Jason Williams interviews were always quite entertaining to me. But that's our guy, Xavier Leggett. Loving on him. See, the Panthers are talking about if they're interested in him. I think we definitely like him to stay closer so we can catch a few more interviews.
Yeah, we got to hear more interviews. And again, if there's nothing else you need a reminder, all you got to do is Google Xavier Leggett riding horses.
Yeah, that's the other thing. But in there, there's the one that's taken off. Am I wrong on this? It's a picture of him and a donkey.
It's a him and a donkey. So he's the horses, donkeys. It's a lot happening. A lot happened with our guy XL, Legette, as we said, from the French side of Mullins.
And if you don't know, this story has started to come out a little bit more. People didn't know it about his parents passing away and his kind of growing up and his upbringing. It really is a great story, the way he's developed.
Yeah, it's a story you want to get behind for sure.
You're around one more segment.
I got one more segment in me.
Preston's got to go actually work today on a Friday. I'm not sure how you fell into that one.
Yeah, I know. I scheduled it.
He'll be around one more segment. We got Chris Deering coming up later on in the 7 o'clock hour. Elijah Campbell is live from Nashville. A lot to do as we roll along on your Friday morning. It's the early game. Bill Gunner for the Men's Clinic. You know what? As we all get older, things start to happen, and they can be tough to explain. And then maybe you just shrug them off. You say, oh, it's just part of getting older. But you know what? It's fixable. And Dr. Dan Balknight at the Men's Clinic, well, they understand that. That's why each individual is treated like an individual. There's no one-size-fits-all approach. So if you've been suffering from low energy levels, lack of drive and motivation, if you had some odd mood changes, anxiety or depression, don't let that affect your life. Have the life that you deserve and start by calling Dr. Dan Balknight today to get a free testosterone test and speak with Dr. Dan Balknight, who's been in the business for over 20 years. That phone number, 803-875-MENS. Again, that's 803-875-MENS. They understand the unique challenges men face and how they can affect your performance at work, home, and at play. So make the phone call today and speak with Dr. Dan Balknight, 803-875-MENS.
Broadcasting live from the Herndon Chevrolet Studios, this is 107.5 The Game.
A great selection of new Chevys is available now at Herndon Chevrolet. The lot is packed with inventory and more is on the way. So shop your hometown Chevy dealer today.
Stop by or shop online today and see why Herndon Chevrolet makes you smile.
Brakes for less. If you have the squeal, we have the deal. Get all four brakes for $239. Brakes for less.
On Friday, March 22nd, a very special night is coming to Columbia. Southern Songwriters with Patrick Davis, a national television show produced for SCE TV and American Public Television, is taping live at the historic Chappelle Auditorium at Allen University. Patrick will be joined by Drew Holcomb, David Ryan Harris, and Sean Mullins. This show will air on more than 300 stations this summer, and you can be part of it. Tickets are on sale at SouthernSongwriters.com or PatrickDavisMusic.com. One night only, March 22nd in Columbia.
The Game On Demand podcast menu.
Sponsored by Lexington Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
If you're dealing with injuries or pain, our team is here to get you better sooner.
107.5 The Game. 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach. 100.5 The Game in Florence.
WIS-TV First Alert Traffic is sponsored by Wetzel's Automotive in West Columbia. Wetzelsauto.com.
And out of the highways, on your Friday morning, we're reporting an accident, Old Barnwell near Sausage Lane. Also, an earlier tie-up, I-77 northbound at I-20. That'd be exit 16. And I-20 westbound between Monticello Road and Broad River Road, we also have a report of an accident. So be careful on your Friday morning, please. 80 for the high today. Evening thunderstorms possible. Tomorrow, 78 for the high, 73 on Sunday. We actually dropped down to 66 on Monday and 59 on Tuesday. So a little bit of temperature swinging going on right now, but it's 54 right now.
WNKT-FM, Eastover, Columbia.
Hey, this is Gamecock catcher Cole Messina. You're listening to the home of the Gamecocks at 107.5 The Game.
Cumulus Media Station.
The Early Game
with Bill Gunter.
I love me some me.
Former Gamecock Preston Thorne.
I don't yuck anybody's yums.
And Jen Jensen.
Let's play a little game real quick.
What?
Jen, somebody calls you and says, Bill's coming on with us. Bill Gunter's coming on with us later today. How should we refer to him?
Schmo.
There you go.
Your home of the Gamecocks in Columbia. 107.5 The Game.
Fine. I'm the one that can't do it. Kids, don't be like me. Be more like Jen.
Be tough.
That's right. Unlike me, be tough.
Also heard on 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach.
The theme of this show. I don't know what happened.
And 100.5 The Game in Florence.
Seven a.m. as we get you going on a Friday morning, as you heard Jen say, we get a little—I wouldn't say it's a cold snap, but it'll cool off just a little after a beautiful day yesterday. That
either
everybody loved or everybody despised because pollen and you wanted to be outside. And
then there was some smoke in the air that I had seen an alert for that, and it's like, oh my gracious!
Yeah, yesterday was one of those beautiful South kind of spring days that were yellow.
Yeah, and also might have caught you off guard if you left early in the morning. And then he's like, oh, it's actually really hot out here.
Yeah, smack you in the face.
Yeah. If you spent the day in the office yesterday and you came outside, he's like, oh, I don't know what happened.
So we'll have a little bit of that, but plenty of basketball to watch as we get you ready here for another game today, South Carolina and Auburn. Yesterday, couple of interesting games yesterday that I was kind of really trying to follow. I think maybe the biggest upset of the day yesterday, or at least according to the rankings, because the biggest upset according to the rankings yesterday was Creighton losing to Devin Carter in Providence. By the way, have you seen Devin Carter's like dramatic rise this year? He's now going to probably be a top 20 NBA pick. He was Big East Player of the Year. He had 22 points yesterday for Providence. Good for him, seeing him go on and excel. And the Friars knocked off number 8 Creighton yesterday. But I thought the biggest upset, North Carolina State taking down Duke. And this just goes back to something we talked about. It's not that I think Duke is falling apart under John Shire and they're going to go to being a team that barely ever makes the NCAA tournament. But you've handed the keys to the Ferrari to a young kid. And right now I feel like it's running low on gas. There's some brake issues. It's not being maintained properly.
Yeah, and again, I don't think anybody around the country feels bad when Duke's losing. You know, I heard the interview with Kyle Filipowski, Flopopowski, maybe we call him. Kyle Flopopowski. And, you know, he just said, oh, yeah, they just wanted it more than us. All right, man. I don't know what to do with that. Okay, cool. The other team wanted it more than you. This is tournament time, dog. What do you want us to say to that?
Again, there's just to me a layer of Duke is not going to be what Duke was. And yesterday they get knocked off 74-69. I'll go back and tell you again what I was kind of mentioning. Love to see them somewhere lined up with South Carolina in the first three rounds. Obviously, they're not going to play Duke in the opening round. South Carolina will be a 5 seed, and we'll talk about this later. Could be a 4 seed with a victory today. Today's the kind of day where you could jump a spot with a victory over Auburn. If you lose, it's not going to have any impact on you. So it just depends on where Duke falls. Who knows? Duke could end up moving to that 4 seed and you get them in the second round. And again, I think the way South Carolina plays is conducive to beating a lot of teams like a Duke or a Kansas. And picking up what would be a signature victory that I think Lamont Paris would really sell on the recruiting trail to go along with his contract extension, to go along with how some guys have performed. I'll say this for Colin Murray Boyles. Not that he's not going to the NBA this year. this is fair or unfair, and it's going to be perfectly fair for Lamont Paris. He gets G.G. Jackson on his track record. And G.G. Jackson is doing really well right now. And he can point, Lamont can point to G.G. Jackson and go, look how he did. Look how he's doing. I'm the one that coached him.
Yeah, absolutely. Every coach gets that. I've told you, the coaches get to put those players on their resume. So when we talked about the transfer portal or guys with one and done, no, those guys go on your resume. It says coach such and such or coach this guy, or he can recruit because he had this exposure to this player. Absolutely, he gets credit for that. And I think when we saw some of the conversations from Gigi, he did hint towards the time in Columbia, though it was didn't go as anybody planned, was really essential in his development as a player for the NBA.
And that's huge because you've seen it. Gigi came back late in the season, was around the program, hyped them up a little bit. I'll say it again, South Carolina yesterday, 80-66 victory. But I don't know if that was the bigger news or the contract extension news.
I think the contract extension is the bigger news because that it wasn't a cloud, but it was an air of suspicion surrounding the program, especially as some of these other jobs were coming open and things were starting to happen. They were having success, and it's nice to have that sort of laid to rest.
Yeah, I was going to say, I think we have sort of felt like if something good happens, it's going to be taken away from us.
In both sports, but in basketball in particular, we haven't seen our coaches wanted. Lou Holtz was up there in age. All right, Steve Spurrier, you kind of knew this was his last gig.
That's good too.
Brad Scott? Nope, nobody wanted that guy. Nice. You can go way back. You go way back in the old time machine. South Carolina panicked a little bit with Will Muschamp. Muschamp had 1 year, and it was like, all right, give him what he wants. Give him everything.
Yep.
And I think Muschamp was heading in that direction, but then obviously it completely fell off. Basketball is kind of the same thing. Look, Eddie Fogler, you weren't really worried about losing. Eddie Fogler, we all kind of knew, was going to quit basketball before really going anywhere else. Dave Odom, no offense to Dave Odom, but Dave Odom was old. Darren Horn had 1 year, and at that point he did get some attention and some love. Xavier at least interviewed him. But then the bottom completely fell out. Frank Martin, and I love Frank. But he's not everybody. He's not every school's cup of tea.
No.
And so you almost didn't worry about losing him. This is the first time I really remember. You know, Ray Tanner's really the only coach I've known at South Carolina that's been wanted by somewhere else, and I think that was Texas A&M way back in the day. Us fans are not used to this.
Mm-hmm.
So we panic a little bit, and it looks like the administration stepped forward and is taking care of it.
Well, I wonder how long the conversations have been being had. When was the topic broached? When did they start having these conversations? Lamont said something interesting. Again, I always just tout his, because he tells us as much as he needs to tell us. He doesn't tell us everything. We don't need to know everything, but he said initially they were planning on putting off the contract discussions. And then he said, well, I can do two things at once. I can focus on two things at once. And he decided that they wanted to move forward with that. That's just thought was really refreshing because a lot of times coaches will be like, oh, it's one day at a time. I'm not thinking about anything. It's like, how could you not be thinking about your future? It's like, that's not human. And so for him to acknowledge that and say, I think we're both in a good spot. I think we can get something done here. I thought he just knocked it out of the park again.
Well, he also has all the leverage.
Of course.
He had every bit of the leverage, and so yes, he could look at it and say, look, let's go ahead and get this done. And one thing that, again, as we learn in year two who Lamont is and what he's about, I think he sees the future. He has nice pieces coming in, and this year is still going to probably be a little bit of a transfer portal year for him in terms of rebuilding the roster. As of today, as we sit here going into game two of the SEC tournament, he is only set to lose three players, Talon Cooper, B.J. Mack, and Stephen Clark. That's it. And if he holds firm on that, you look around and go, man, that's a pretty nice foundation. Now, B.J. Mack and Talon Cooper are massive parts of this roster. But you go, man, that's a pretty nice foundation for next year. And then you have some really nice recruits coming in. That's why I said earlier, this is probably the most momentum I've seen South Carolina basketball with since somewhere around 96, 97, 98 in that little span of Eddie Fogler.
Yeah, and with the contract being extended, the general consensus is everybody's like, yes, let's do it. You know, let's move forward. Let's continue to see what he can grow. And what can he grow with some confidence in knowing that this is the place that's supporting him? What kind of different long-term strategic moves can he make knowing that this is where he's going to be for, you know, for the foreseeable future, which, Bill, is 2030. What is that? How does that even, how do you even write that on a calendar? 2030? What are we talking about?
Yeah, we had a text.
How did this happen?
If I can go back and find it, somebody weighed in this morning and was like, when they saw the contract, they're like, a 30-year contract. And they came back and said, I didn't realize it was already 2024. Like,
how do we even start having these conversations? Well, 2030, what are we talking about?
Oh, that's what, hey, we schedule football games the way through 2035, 2036.
Wow.
But Lord willing,
we'll all be here for this.
This is a commitment. I mean, this is South Carolina committing to Lamont Paris. This is Lamont Paris committing to South Carolina.
I think more so that. I mean, I think we've found somebody who's excited, but Lamont's stock is rising. And so for him to say, like, I want to plant seeds here, when it looks like his stock is going to continuously rise, and no disrespect to South Carolina, but there are more premier jobs. It's more of him saying, I want to be here.
And he has the opportunity now to make this a premier destination like Dawn did. You know, she came here and faith and a lot of hard work and strength and building, and she's built a dynasty and a premier program. So would that not be cool to watch him now do the same thing?
Well, here's what I wonder, because this is to each his own, and I can't get into Lamont Paris's mindset and what he wants or what any other coach would want. But the allure of doing something, Steve Spurrier was the one that really brought it to our attention, to do something that's never been done. That was his big thing about coming to this university. And Frank McGuire had an incredible run in the 70s. Well, I don't know how many. I know there are people out there that remember it, but there's a lot of people that don't.
We're talking about 2030.
Well, here's the – this is – Lamont Paris can be synonymous with South Carolina. Like, this is his baby. And I don't know what the allure of some coaches are to do it completely on that. That's theirs. Dawn, South Carolina, no matter whatever happens moving forward, South Carolina and Dawn Staley will be linked together. This will be her program, whoever coaches here. Whomever comes in over the next 50 or 60 years will always have to live up to Dawn Staley.
Don't you have to, just talking about women's basketball, it takes me training to say, oh, yeah, Pat Summitt, Tennessee. Oh, she's, oh, yeah, it's Kelly Harper, my fault. I still think Pat Summitt. I still think these certain people with specific jobs. So, yeah, you're right. Maybe there is some allure of being able to say that's his job, that's their job. They built that.
This is his lump of clay.
Yep.
And
I mean, you can, if you think about certain programs, like, nothing against Nick Saban, but is Nick Saban ever going to truly, even though he's got more championships and the success was far greater, is he ever really Bear Bryant?
Good question.
That doesn't matter what happens at Florida State. Will anybody ever truly be Bobby Bowden?
Good question.
There are coaches who can get that opportunity to make that program truly there. Dawn Staley has done that. I think Ray Tanner, despite success prior to him with Bobby Richardson, with June Raines, with those, we still do it. Every coach that ever coaches baseball at the University of South Carolina, we will always go, you're not Ray Tanner. Oh, that's nice, but you're not Ray Tanner.
Interesting to become a measuring stick.
Mm-hmm. And Lamont Paris, this is a, as you just said, an unmolded lump of clay that Lamont Paris can completely make his own and forever be. Now, if you go to Ohio State, you know, if you go back to Wisconsin, if you took the Louisville job, you're never going to, you'll be a coach there and you can be well respected and loved here.
So he's going to take that lump of clay and going to make it the Venus de Milo or Venus, whatever it's called. Yeah.
Well,
it sounded like Bill for a second when I wasn't articulating the piece of art.
Here's what it is. If he has success, if he has success over the next 2 or 3 years, serious success in 15 years, he could be recruiting a lot of kids named Lamont out of the Columbia area.
I feel like Lamont is one of those. If we look at the baby Google trending, I think Lamont's been trending down for a lot of years.
He's got a chance to bring it back. Wow.
If he brings Lamont's back, that would be his crowning achievement.
Lamont probably hasn't been good since about the 70s with Sanford and Son.
I feel like Lamont is trending
down. I'm just
saying,
he could. Look. The world is his oyster right now with the University of South Carolina basketball. You got to get out of here.
Yeah, man. We'll see. We'll see on Monday. Hopefully, we'll find out a lot of information on Monday.
Yep, we will be breaking it down. I'll be back. Chris Deering joins me next. You're listening to The Early Game.
The Game Network.
The home of the Gamecocks. 107.5, The Game in Columbia. 100.5, The Game in Florence. 100.3, The Game in Myrtle Beach.
Also on the 107.5, The Game app. And streaming live on The Game TV. Ever been on this date?
You're a good-looking man.
Thank you.
Very pretty. Real soft, delicate features. They're real feminine.
And thought, man, I'd rather be listening to The Game right now.
Welcome in to the afternoon show. Alongside Elijah Campbell, I'm Jay Phillips.
Well, just go to iTunes or Google Play and download The Game app. Sure, you may no longer be with that person anymore, but you'll never be without The Game again.
Yeah, that pollen, it was something special yesterday, and it's not going to get better for a few days. And you know what? That leads to more spring cleaning, which takes up more of your time. And that's unfortunate because there's a lot of great things on television right now. But I've got the perfect spring cleaning hack for you. ZRS Carpet and Air Duct Cleaning. They use their patented ZR water technology that cleans better than detergents while leaving behind zero residue. That's right. The carpets will be great. You can roll around on them. The pets can feel comfortable. You can feel great with your kids playing on the carpets, rugs, tile upholstery. ZRS Carpet and Air Duct Cleaning and that patented ZR water technology are absolutely second to none. Take advantage of their spring sale right now. Mention me, Bill Gunner, at 107.5 The Game, and get three rooms of carpet clean for $129 plus a free hallway. 803-262-4020, or you can book online, zeroscolumbia.com. Again, three rooms of carpet clean for $129 plus a free hallway. Zero, spell it backwards and forwards. It's the right way to clean.
The Game.
Broadcasting live from the Herndon Chevrolet Studios.
Discover Herndon Certified. Herndon Chevrolet is premier used car warranty. Shop with complete confidence, knowing Herndon Chevrolet has got you covered.
Stop by or shop online today and see why Herndon Chevrolet makes you smile.
Plus text seconds entitled with proof critical 866-243-4623 for details. We interrupt this broadcast with an important news alert. There's a slasher on the loose. JT's Chrysler Jeep Dodge Ram is slashing prices. New Rams were $12,000 off, slashed to $14,000 off. New Jeeps were $10,000 off, slashed to $12,000 off. This just in, new Chargers and Challengers slashed $10,000 off. Now here's the weather. Whether or not your credit is cloudy, JT sees sunny days ahead. Nobody fights harder to get you approved. JT's Chrysler Jeep Dodge Ram, Greystone Boulevard and 378 Lexington. Jeep celebration event.
The second annual Mega Gun and Knife Show is this weekend at the State Fairgrounds, and it's the largest gun and knife show ever held in Columbia. This is not just a gun show. It's an event. Two huge buildings and over 650 tables of rifles, shotguns, handguns, knives, ammo, antiques, military displays.
Elijah confirmed 8.
Sell and trade. Food vendors and educational exhibits are on site, so bring the whole family. The Mega Gun and Knife Show is brought to you by the South Carolina Arms Collectors Association, and it's the real deal. This Saturday and Sunday at the South Carolina State Fairgrounds, scgunshows.com.
You already know that Palmetto Citizens Federal Credit Union offers truly free checking and great rates on auto loans, but did you know they do mortgages too? Whether you need a first or second mortgage, a home equity line of credit, or a loan for construction, renovation, a lot, or a manufactured home, Palmetto Citizens has you covered. They're a community financial institution based solely here in the Midlands, so they offer a refreshingly simple mortgage process you won't get from the big banks or online lenders. Along with a great rate, the Palmetto Citizens Mortgage Team will work with you to tailor the loan to best fit your needs and budget. Apply for your mortgage today by visiting palmettocitizens.org or stopping by any of their 14 branches across the Midlands. Palmetto Citizens, proudly serving this community since 1936. Equal Housing Lender, NMLS ID number 449962. Approval based on credit worthiness. Certain restrictions may apply.
No one likes to talk about the injuries, pain, disability, and lost loved ones that result from terrible car and tractor-trailer accidents. I'm Jason Reynolds. At the Samuels Reynolds Law Firm, we're honored to be the lawyers our clients rely on during their toughest moments.
And I'm Steven Samuels. When work injury disrupts your life, I work hard to get you the medical treatment and workers' compensation you depend on.
Samuels Reynolds. True injuries, true lawyers. 803-779-4000.
Powered by Integrated Media, The Game TV.
Sponsored by Shepherd's Glass, a true reflection of quality.
The Game TV.
Sponsored by Shepherd's Glass.
There's no better place to be in the spring than at Founders Park, cheering on the Gamecock baseball team. Get your single game tickets today. Tickets start as low as $12. Visit GamecocksOnline.com to get yours today.
WIST-TV First Alert Traffic is sponsored by Wetzel's Automotive in West Columbia. Wetzelsauto.com.
So I-20 westbound at between Monticello Road and Broad River Road still causing a little bit of a tie-up there. Also Barnwell Road near Sausage Lane and 277 northbound at I-77. And we're... Sorry, I had a little glitch in the headphones there. So anyway, as far as your forecast goes, we are looking at a high today of just about 81, which would be great. 78 tomorrow, 73 on Sunday, 54 right now on the early game.
Early game
with Bill Gunter, Preston Thorne, and Jen Jensen.
Your home of the Gamecocks in Columbia. 107.5 The Game.
Also heard on 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach
and 100.5 The Game in Florence.
Alex weighs in this morning on our Firehouse Subs text line, 803-404-6100. I have a feeling Paris would trend better than Lamont for baby names in the Midlands. Love the show, though. Love how y'all cover the important topics like hypothetical baby name trends. God bless. Thank you, Alex. Hope you're all doing well this morning as we get you up and get you going. Want to remind you, baseball this weekend, and you can go to 1075thegame.com and register for the Palmetto Citizens FCU Grand Slam giveaway. Every game has $25 added to the pot. And if a Gamecock hitter hits a Grand Slam, you can win all the cash in the pot. Right now, $450. That's all the cash in the pot. Go to 1075thegame.com and register the Palmetto Citizens FCU Grand Slam giveaway. Again, right now that pot is up to $450. So get yourself on over, sign up, and get registered at 1075thegame.com, and you have a chance to win all the cash in the pot if a Gamecock hitter slaps a Grand Slam this weekend or tonight. So go ahead and make sure you do that. Thank you to Palmetto Citizens FCU for, again, their Grand Slam giveaway. Joining us now, as he does each and every week, out on the Love Chevy phone lines, Chris Deering for the high school highlights of the week. And Chris, it's been a few weeks since I've been able to talk to you. I was out last Friday, and Friday before we were getting ready, I believe, for state championships, and we were kind of in a rush. But man, it's been a busy few weeks real quick, and we're going to get to a great football combine you have coming up. But let me just ask real quick your takeaways, since I didn't get to talk to you, from the high school basketball championships.
You know, there's been a lot of discussion since the championships happened a couple weeks ago about the venue in Florence and how it, you know, worked for everyone and how it was presented as to everyone. And, you know, most of the feedback I got while being down there was the coaches liked the one venue plan, you know, having all the games, the semifinals and the championship games all in one site. I don't think they were fully sold on Florence being that site. you know, there. So there's got to be some upgrades to that facility if they want to continue to have it down there. The lighting is a little bit needs to some improvement. The scoreboards definitely need some improvement, and the just the overall feel of that arena I think needs some improvement. But overall, I think it was a good experience for everybody that was down there. You know, we saw some great games for the championships. You know, Lexington won. AC Floor girls got beat in the championship. The Great Collegiate boys won a good game over Oceanside Collegiate. Ridgeview won a championship. You know, three of the five boys championships came from right here in the Midlands. So that was a pretty big get for that crowd. So I thought it was a good setting overall. I do know that for next year, you know, this is a one year thing. It's not, you don't sign a series of staying in one place for years. So it was a 1 year deal. I know next year there's some other players trying to get into the game, the North Charleston Coliseum in Charleston, the place up in Greenville, whatever it's called now, Bond Secure. Is it still Bond Secure? I don't know.
That's what I've got it as, yes.
Okay, it changes names pretty regularly. I can't keep up with what that one is. I think Florence is back in the discussion. So the high school league's got a lot of decisions to make. I do like the format of having the semifinals and finals in the same arena. But, you know, if you go to Greenville, if you go to Charleston, you can have teams complaining about the travel. And I understand. And the other part of it is you're playing games during the weekday. They start at 2:00. And next year, with the way they have the region set in the 5A splitting into two state championships in all sports, not just football, you throw in another day's worth of games and then two more championships into the mix. So a lot to figure out, and let's just hope everything works out. The Basketball Coaches Association, they will be heavily involved as well. So those guys will be making a decision on that here in the next couple of months, and we'll see where it goes.
Again, something we'll follow as we get into the offseason. Hard to believe it's – I was telling Preston when we started March 15th already. Before you know it, we will be fully immersed in spring high school practice as well as the start of the fall football season. And you've got some combines coming up that you're really excited about. Gets going this weekend.
Yeah, this weekend is our first Carolina Coaches Combine. This goes a long ways in selecting the Touchdown Energy North-South players. And it's just a really good opportunity for guys to get out and be seen. I do think some college coaches can attend these combines. The first one is tomorrow at Woodland High School down in the Lowcountry. Next weekend, there's one over at West Florence. And then in April, we have two more at York High School and Spartanburg High. So a lot of good football players will be running through those combines. You know, you sort of competing with some junior days across, you know, some colleges are having junior days and stuff right now. But I've looked at the list of kids in these combines. The format is the morning time, you'll have the rising seniors. They will go from, I don't know, about 8:30 to 11:30. And then the underclassmen, the 2026 and 2027 kids will go in the afternoon. So a lot of good football players are going to be at these combines. Like I said, I'm going down to Woodland tomorrow. They're taking that first one and really excited to see a lot of those kids and what they can provide.
If people want to get registered, how does that work there? If people want to register or bring their son, or do you know?
Well, I think the registration for tomorrow is already closed. Next, for the other ones, I think it's still open. But I honestly don't know. If you go to the Carolina Coaches Combine site, Twitter or X handle, they have a lot of information on there. I know that's what I was looking at the roster just last night while I was watching some basketball, but just seeing who all would be at the Woodland Combine. But that's the best place to go that I know. I don't know what the registration process is exactly. I do know that a lot of this was invitation. A lot of kids were invited to come to these combines, and from what I understand, the majority of them accepted. So I don't know if it's if you can do a walk-up registration or anything like that, but I do know that a lot of these are invite kids and kids that are expected to be, you know, big-time players over the next 2 or 3 years.
we'll keep you updated on more of that in the coming weeks, so that if you want to try and get your son out to one of these football combines there, we will certainly keep Chris keep you updated there, as I know he'll be out there covering. 803-404-6100. When we come back, we'll actually get into a little bit of baseball and softball with Chris Deering. Baseball and softball season, lacrosse, spring, track and field, everything heating up. We'll get a little bit of a breakdown from Chris Deering as we roll along. You're listening to Bill Gunner, Jen Jensen, and he's Chris Deering joining us as he does on Fridays for the high school highlights of the week. It's the Early Game.
The Game Network.
The home of the Gamecocks. 107.5, The Game in Columbia. 100.5, The Game in Florence. 100.3, The Game in Myrtle Beach.
Also on the 107.5, The Game app. And streaming live on The Game TV. Powered by...
Baseline, shoots it up over Vanover. Got it!
I take a lot of pride in being from South Carolina. It's part of why I chose the school. I just wanted them to know, man, I got love for this school. I think the school loves me as well. And just a guy that gave it his all while he was here and just made continuous improvement and just a winner, man. A guy that really wanted to win and left it all on the court every time.
Everyone says they care about the team and they care about winning, but, you know, this group especially is all about winning.
When I'm in the huddle with my teammates, when we're on the road, when we're going up against somebody, I just always tell them, be us. Be who we are. Don't try to be nobody else. Like, you can look at it and be like, well, doing something right now. You know what I'm saying? We just want to stay on that path. You know, stay on that path to greatness and stay on that path to March.
On to 1075thegame.com and click on Sweet Deals to get your $50 to O'Hara's Public House for just $25.
Honda ATVs and side-by-sides have a rock-solid reputation, and now you can get even more out of your new Honda with incredible deals on accessories. For a limited time, select Honda ATVs come with up to $300 in accessory savings, while select Honda side-by-sides come with up to $1,000 in accessory savings. Just head to Carolina Honda Powerhouse in Columbia and save big on accessories today. Carolina Honda Powerhouse, exit 70 off I-20, or visit CarolinaHonda.com. Honda accessory rebate offer is valid with the purchase of a new and unregistered 2024 and prior ATV, Pioneer, and Talon models. Check with Carolina Honda Powerhouse for complete details.
Take a moment and think of one thing that you really wanted to do recently, but you didn't because your foot, leg, or back pain got in the way. Hi, it's Dan from the Good Feet Store, and that's why we're here, to help you get back out there. Good Feet Arch Supports from the Good Feet Store are designed to alleviate foot, knee, hip, and back pain, plus provide improved balance, more comfort, and, well, a better life. Try them for yourself with a free arch support fitting at the Good Feet Store.
The Good Feet Store. Call 1-800-NEW-FEET or visit goodfeet.com.
Powered by Integrated Media, The Game TV.
Sponsored by Shepherd's Glass, a true reflection of quality.
The Game TV.
Sponsored by Shepherd's Glass.
JT's Kia Mania is back, and we're giving away two brand new Kias. Be there this Saturday at 5 p.m. No purchase necessary. Just come in and register at either location. JT's Kia, Greystone Boulevard or Killian Road. Don't miss this giveaway.
Music fans, on Friday, March 22nd, a very special night is coming to Columbia. Southern Songwriters with Patrick Davis, a national television show produced for SCE TV and American Public Television, is taping live at the historic Chappelle Auditorium at Allen University. Patrick will be joined by Drew Holcomb, David Ryan Harris, and Sean Mullins. This show will air on more than 300 stations this summer, and you can be part of it. Tickets are on sale at SouthernSongwriters.com or PatrickDavisMusic.com. One night only, March 22nd in Columbia.
What's up, folks? Anthony Armstrong here.
Bob Pop, along with Super Bowl champion Carl Banks.
Hey, NFL fans. This is Solomon Wilcox, former NFL safety and host of the Believe in Bengals podcast. Catch my show and all 32 Believe NFL podcasts. Listen in to former players give their inside perspective on your favorite team. Search Believe, that's B-L-E-A-V, on Apple, Spotify, and wherever you get your podcasts.
It's always football season, wherever you listen.
The Game on Demand podcast menu.
Sponsored by Lexington Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
If you're dealing with injuries or pain, our team is here to get you better sooner.
107.5 The Game. 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach. 100.5 The Game in Florence.
WIST-TV First Alert Traffic is sponsored by Wetzel's Automotive in West Columbia. Wetzelsauto.com.
You're talking about. Sponsored by Love Chevrolet.
On your home of the Gamecocks in Columbia, 107.5 The Game.
Also heard on 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach and 100.5 The Game in Florence.
Reminder is always, so many ways you can join us each and every morning. Boy, if you, you want to join us, you want to be a part of the program in some way, shape, or form, it's not hard to do. And if you don't like us, well, it's kind of hard to avoid us. You can listen, as always, right here in Columbia, 107.5 The Game, 100.5 The Game in Florence, and 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach. You can download our app. Just go to your app store and download the 107.5 The Game app. We even have multiple ways to stream. You can go to YouTube.com and stream the early games. Just search the early game. You can hop in our chat room where York, Hope, RL, Gamecock fan, Craig, Mike, Steven, they're all in there. A bunch of people in there chit-chatting, talking about last night's big victory or yesterday's big victory, looking ahead to today's Auburn game. So you can do that. Or you can stream us on the Game TV, sponsored by Shepherd's Glass. So multiple ways for you to be a part of the program each and every morning. And we appreciate each and every one of you who joins us and chit-chats, talks, becomes a part of the program, offers your own thoughts and opinions on certain things. 803-404-6100. How you can weigh us? Back out to the Love Chevy phone lines. Chris Deering joining us of Prep Red Zone. It is the high school highlights of the week. And baseball is in full effect, Chris Deering. A lot of baseball across the Midlands. Let's just start with the 5A region. As to who is performing the best right now?
Well, you know, we've got a couple of games under our belt. There's not been any new rankings since the preseason rankings came out. But, you know, you sort of got to see the lay of the land a little bit with some of these early season games. And I think River Bluff in 5A is right there. They're defending state champ. And I think they're going to be a team that's going to be there in the end again this year. Bo Hollins, we've talked about him. We talked about him last year. He's really good. He's probably going to be a draft pick in the early rounds, just coming up in the major league draft. He's committed to South Carolina. Let's hope the Gamecocks can get him on campus, but they will be competing against Major League Baseball probably for his services. But River Bluff's been really good. Lexington's been good so far. Blythewood is young. They've got some injuries, but they've been playing pretty well. I know last week Lexington and Blythewood split a pair of games, so that was good for both of those programs going forward. And, you know, that's probably the top 5A schools in this area. Looking at the preseason poll and then looking at what's been going on so far in the early season. I did have one question. Is Preston in this morning?
He is not. Well, he was. He is off to work with the kids on the reading.
Gotcha, because I did go down to Berkeley and Somerville this week on Tuesday night. Last-minute impulse decision, drove down to the hometown and saw Berkeley and Somerville put on a classic. They played a 1-0 10-inning game. So that was pretty pretty good to see that the Stags came out on top. So they made my trip worthwhile.
Very nice. Okay, there you go. Happy for you to have a little something on Preston Thorne. He'll be back next week, and just remember to remind him of that. Switch over to softball with 5A and how performances are going so far here early in the season.
You know, looking at softball, I think you got to look at Chapin. They've been really good here in the early going. Blythewood has been good. Again, Lexington has been, you know, pretty good early on. White Knoll struggled a little bit. They're historically really good, but they've struggled out the gate a little bit. But I do expect, you know, that Chapin team might be one of the better in the state. There's no softball poll, so you just got to sort of search around for those. And I do watch the results pretty good on X. That's the best place to get Twitter. And then I'm big on Game Changer. I'll probably follow every school I can that does update Game Changer. And so that's a lot of fun to look at. I'll probably look every night. I'm probably addicted to this stuff and shouldn't be, but look every night at Game Changer to see who's done what. But yeah, I like those three teams right there, Blythewood, Chapin, and Lexington in softball. I think those are probably the top three in 5A.
And we do have a quick update. Text message comes in on the personal text line from Preston Thorne. It just says, "Hey, Chris, I heard that." So I'll let you too. Work that one out there with your Berkeley Stags and his Somerville Greenway. We had a lot of fun yesterday with John Alston being in here with Preston and cutting up and reliving some of their memories.
You know, I listened to that. That was a good segment. That Jonathan Alston was really good yesterday, I thought.
Yeah, he was fantastic. He's fantastic. Great guy. We look forward to having him back here hopefully soon. 4A softball and baseball. Kind of give us the rundown there.
We'll start with baseball, I guess. You know, baseball is pretty good in the 4A ranks, and we can look at some of the teams at the beach on this one as well, and in the Florence area. North Myrtle Beach has been really good. They were preseason number two, so that's a good program to watch going forward. Lugoff Elgin's here locally. AC Floor has been pretty good out of the gate. Airport, I think, is going to be a team in the mix at the very end as well. And then West Florence has been pretty good so far in this early season. So a lot of good baseball in 4A ranks and here at the beach and also in the Florence area. So a lot of good teams there. And then on the softball side of things, you got to look at, I think AC Floor has been really good coming out early season. Airport has struggled a little bit. AC Floor has struggled a little bit. But I think, not AC Floor. Irmo struggled a little bit. AC Floor might be the best team in the softball ranks here in the Midlands.
Just a few minutes left. 3A, real quick, before we move on to one other topic I want to get to. How does 3A look with baseball and softball?
3A, you got to start with Gilbert. They're historically really good. They usually play deep into the playoffs. That's for both softball and baseball. Ainer, I think, is really good in baseball for the beach people out there listening. And then also, I think Camden's been pretty good early season baseball. So that's probably the top teams right there. Softball, I don't know much about the 3A ranks just yet. That's some of the harder scores to get. But I do think Gilbert's going to be really good in softball going forward.
He's Chris Deering joining us as he does each and every week for the high school highlights of the week. But I want to transition real quick here before we get you out of here, just about 2 minutes left. Your thoughts on this Lamont Paris contract extension? You've covered South Carolina basketball. You've seen it. You're familiar with basketball in the Midlands. But your take on South Carolina and this contract extension?
I thought it was very much needed. I think, you know, a lot of people, when they hired Lamont Paris, were not high on the hire. And then last year, with the struggles they had, you heard some rumblings that, you know, that South Carolina settled and they didn't get the best candidate. But I think Lamont Paris has done an absolutely fantastic job this year. That team is fun to watch. And you know, I'm not a coach, but I've been around the game a long time. But you just watch some of the things he does in game, like yesterday switching to that 1-3-1. That just gives teams fits for whatever reason. I guess with Zach Davis out front really helps that 1-3-1 zone. And then you look at the substitution patterns as well. You know, I call it sometimes buying minutes, and he's getting some guys some rest and getting some guys in there that's, you know, getting some good minutes and providing some depth, but he's getting the starters some rest. So I think Lamont Paris has done a great job. I do think he's very well liked in the coaching ranks in South Carolina. And, you know, that's a big thing if he wants to get kids locally. I know he's recruiting some kids locally in the state of South Carolina. So that's a big time. I think that's the right move for the program right now. And I'm excited for, you know, watching these next few games, hopefully this weekend and then into the NCAA tournament.
Chris, man, we always appreciate it. A lot of information to get to today, and you did a great job. We look forward to having you back next week.
All right, sounds good. Y'all have a great weekend.
You too. Chris Deering, follow him on Twitter at cdeering82 is how you can do that. It's the high school highlights of the week there. A lot of good information. We'll come back. We'll wrap up hour two. Elijah Campbell set to join us in hour three as he is live from Nashville. You're listening to The Early Game.
The Game Network.
The home of the Gamecocks. 107.5 The Game in Columbia. 100.5 The Game in Florence. 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach.
Also on the 107.5 The Game app. And streaming live on The Game TV. Yes, that phone in your pocket or purse will keep you in touch with your family and friends. It will take great selfies of you on amazing adventures or just this morning's breakfast. And it's pretty good in case of an emergency. But the single most important function of your phone is the game.
But both defenses have been this year. What's so funny?
The noise.
You can listen anywhere. Just go to iTunes or Google Play and download the game app now.
More rain expected in the forecast this weekend and moving forward. And the question for me to you is, how is your roof holding up? Have you even thought about it? You need to. I know you think about a lot of other things in life, but what about your roof? Making sure that there's some leak detection. And if that's something that you've been thinking about, now you go, ooh, I better check on that. Well, guess what? Call Mid-State Roofing. Larry Leitner, owner, founder, his family, they have taken care of people for nearly 30 years, making sure that their businesses are dry and they're running properly. So you need to call Mid-State Roofing today. They got a 24-hour day, 7-day-a-week call center that is ready to help you even at 7:46 on a Friday morning. 803-356-1919. Again, that's 803-356-1919. You can visit them on the web for more information, midstateroofing.com. But call today. Get a leak detection plan and a maintenance contract in place. It's Mid-State Roofing. If you've got a leak, let Mid-State Roofing take a peek.
This is JR from the JR Sport Brief with the CBS Sports Minute, sponsored by LL Flooring. LL Flooring, every step covered. The NBA is going through its stretch run, and a player again who won't be available is Ben Simmons. The man is having his second back surgery in 3 seasons, and backs are no joke.
Prices? Well, we're burning rubber, not cash. Keep your ride or die alive at ebaymotors.com. Eligible items only. Exclusion.
There's something remarkable about the University of South Carolina. It's in the labs, where researchers are discovering ways to make communities healthier and stronger. It's in the nation's best first-year student experience, in top-rate programs in nursing and health sciences. It's where more South Carolina students have access to higher education than ever before. Because when you stand for something bigger than yourself, you could create something that benefits us all. Behold, the remarkable we. There's something remarkable about the University of South Carolina. It's in the labs, where researchers are discovering ways to make communities healthier and stronger. It's in the nation's best first-year student experience, in top-ranked programs in nursing and health sciences.
It's where more South Carolina students have access to higher education than ever before. Because when you stand for something bigger than yourself, you can create something that benefits us all. Behold, the remarkable we.
Game
with Bill Gunter, Preston Thorne, and Jen Jensen.
Your home of the Gamecocks in Columbia, 107.5 The Game.
Also heard on 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach and 100.5 The Game in Florence.
A reminder, a couple weeks from today, April 5th, that's a Friday, Charwood Golf Club. It is the 107.5 The Game Spring Golf Tournament. 10 a.m. shotgun start. We'll have breakfast. We'll have lunch. We're going to have all kinds of raffles and giveaways. All participants have a chance to win a pair of tickets to each home Gamecock baseball game for the remainder of the season. Call today out to Charwood and get registered. 803-755-2000. Again, it's 803-755-2000. That'll get you registered. Rock and Daniel Lucas, they're ready to host us. We're ready to see them, and we're ready to see you. So you need to call today. These spots go fast. We got about 28 spots available, and you need to call today, 803-755-2000. Again, this tournament would be April the 5th. That's a Friday. It is Final Four weekend, also the weekend before the Masters, but it is Final Four weekend, and hopefully we'll be gearing up for Dawn Staley in South Carolina for both teams.
So for us, for the golf tournament, it's the Final Four. Right? Pretty good.
You're very happy with yourself right now.
Kind of am a little bit.
That fist pump was a bit excessive, but yep, that is exactly right. Final Four. Yeah. Good job. Good job. It is a good play on words. Look at you. That is a marketing major right there, knowing what she's doing. Call out to Charwood and get registered so you can hear more jokes in person from Jen Jensen. Maybe we'll even have a special joke segment with Jen Jensen that day. You need to come on out. We want to see
Dare
you.
Dare to dream. It's not the price of admission doesn't even cover it.
I'm always the one that has to do the hosting, like the kind of the emceeing of it. Mm-hmm. And maybe I'll just turn that over to you this year.
Could be entertaining.
With your entertainment. Call out today, 803-755-2000. Each foursome, it's $400. $100 per person, $400 for the team. We want to see you. That's April the 5th, again, with 10 a.m. shotgun start. Preston, Jen, myself will be out there broadcasting, and we definitely look forward to hopefully seeing you then. So call today, 803-755-2000, and get registered. Yesterday, Lamont Paris agreed. We'll learn more today. Board of Trustees meeting coming up later on this morning. We'll learn more about the financial aspects of this contract extension. All the talk about it, almost going back 2 months now to mid-January. All right, what's South Carolina going to do? How are they going to handle it? How are they going to take care of Lamont Paris? How are they going to secure an up-and-comer coach? Well, they did it. And yesterday, Lamont Paris talked about the foundation at the University of South Carolina, saying here's what he had to say after the Arkansas game.
I knew the foundation was really good. It is. It's rock solid. It's steady. It's up to code in every single way. And so over the next years, we'll be continuing to bring in more materials and vet those out and make sure that those are the right materials that we need to do that too. But, you know, I didn't float my name around. A lot of people were floating my name around. I guess that's what happens this time of year. And it's fun. It's exciting. There's a lot of things that are going on. It makes the number of text messages I get out of control. But we've been so focused on a mission that we have here with this team and so enthralled in trying to get better and to get to the next thing that's what we were really focused on. In fact, when it was first presented to me, my natural instinct was to kind of push it back a little bit so that we could continue to do that, right? At full throttle. And then I realized that you can multitask if you really want to do that. So we were able to move forward on that. And I'm really, really excited about that. And then still quickly be able to get back to pouring more into our preparation and getting these guys ready to go out there and show what they can do.
So I have a question. did he at one point work for a construction firm?
He knew all about it, didn't he?
Boy, he has all of the analogies have to do with building a house, which I think is great because it's a great way to explain things. But I'm becoming more fascinated. Like, you know, we're looking to build a house in another year or two, and maybe I should call him because he doesn't have a lot going on right now.
No, so not much at all.
Just interested.
He's right about the foundation. And I've said it multiple times this morning, and Preston kind of alluded to it, talking about being out and about yesterday and the excitement of South Carolina basketball here in the Midlands. I don't know if I've seen South Carolina with this much momentum. Young, up-and-coming coach. Recruiting is going very well. They've got something to really build off of. Who knows where this run will take them. We're going to talk with Elijah Campbell coming up here in about 6 minutes, who's up in Nashville, about today's Auburn game. As South Carolina will look to kind of bounce back from that 40-point loss they suffered in Auburn back in mid-February. But this is a great time for South Carolina. We'll see where it goes. We'll see where it goes. But as we sit here on March the 15th of 2024, it feels like South Carolina is in a different direction than I've ever seen them as it pertains to basketball. So we'll talk more about that as we roll along. Elijah Campbell set to join us. Bill Gunner, Jen Jensen, hour three on the way.
Broadcasting live from the Herndon Chevrolet Studios, this is 107.5 The Game.
A great selection of new Chevys is available now at Herndon Chevrolet.
Oh, man.
Okay, this might be my favorite moment of 2023, taking place on November 9th, a Thursday morning at the 107.5 The Game Studios. A victory lap for us. Thank you to Jen Jensen for her outstanding work with the cell phone camera as we invaded the early game studios with the Corley Pool Solutions Checkered Flag Challenge Trophy, much to the dismay of one of the hosts who shall remain nameless, but that's his most photogenic angle. If you listen to the early game in the mornings, you know that he who shall remain nameless, Jen Jensen, former Gamecock Preston Thorne, and the now retired Darlington Raceway President Kerry Tharp, compete in this NASCAR contest where we pick one driver for each race. You get bonus points if you pick the winner. The better the finish, the more points you get. It started in February with Stenhouse, my pick. And it ran all the way through early November. And for the second year in a row, yours truly came away with the trophy. Joshua contributed with a Michael McDowell pick at Indy, which was a home run pick for sure. He laughed at me, by the way, when I took Stenhouse at Daytona, for what it's worth. But this is a serious contest. And if I had to choose between winning a fantasy football title with my buddies and this contest, not even a question. So we'll go for three in a row in 2024. And I already have Stenhouse set for Daytona, so perhaps he can win his second consecutive Super Bowl of stock car racing. So looking forward to an exciting 2024. And there's Kerry Tharp, again, retiring as Darlington Raceway president in his last race back on Labor Day weekend, the Cookout Southern 500. And there he is getting a selfie with the race winner, Kyle Larson, who was also one of my picks during the year. So it's a fun year in 2023 competing for the trophy. And again, we'll go for three in a row next year.
Check with every new Kia. JT's Kia Mania is back.
Worry less about spring cleaning and call Zerus Carpet and Air Duct Cleaning. Mention me, Bill Gunner, at 107.5 The Game, and you'll get three rooms of carpet clean for $129 plus a free hallway. Book online at ZerusColumbia.com.
Music fans, on Friday, March 22nd, a very special night is coming to Columbia. Southern Songwriters with Patrick Davis, a national television show produced for SCE-TV and American Public Television, is taping live at the historic Chappelle Auditorium at Allen University. Patrick will be joined by Drew Holcomb, David Ryan Harris, and Sean Mullins. This show will air on more than 300 stations this summer, and you can be part of it. Tickets are on sale at SouthernSongwriters.com or PatrickDavisMusic.com. One night only, March 22nd in Columbia.
Hit us up on the Firehouse Subs text line, 803-404-6100.
Your home of the Gamecocks in Columbia, 107.5 The Game. Also heard on 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach and 100.5 The Game in Florence.
WIST-TV First Alert Traffic is sponsored by Wetzel's Automotive in West Columbia. Wetzel'sAuto.com.
And looking at your traffic conditions for your Friday morning, we see that an accident, I-77 southbound at Forest Drive. I-26 eastbound at exit 91, a slowdown there as well. Earlier accidents have been cleared. Great news for this morning. And we're looking for a high today of 80 with some evening thunderstorms possible. 78 for the high tomorrow, 73 on Sunday. And by Monday, we're down to 66, 59 on Tuesday. So a little bit of a roller coaster. So we'll soak in the sun, or at least the warmth while we can. Right now, it's 54 on the early game.
WNKTFM, Eastover, Columbia.
This is defensive lineman Alex Hundley, and you're listening to Home of the Gamecocks, 107.5 The Game.
A Cumulus Media Station.
The early game
with Bill Gunter.
I love this photo.
Former Gamecock Preston Thorne and Jen Jensen.
My eyes look phenomenal. The blue in my eyes stands out so well.
The day of the photos, I believe the quote was, "I love how it makes my eyes pop."
My eyes pop, yeah. Yeah,
it does.
Your home of the Gamecocks in Columbia, 107.5 The Game.
I love me some meat.
Also heard on 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach.
The theme of this show. I don't know what happened.
And 100.5 The Game in Florence.
Hour three as we get you up and get you going this morning on a Friday morning. Conference tournament Friday, and yesterday, South Carolina rolling over Arkansas 80-66. It was a kind of a close game there at halftime. It looked like Arkansas might put a little bit of a scare into the 15th-ranked Gamecocks, but the second half, South Carolina took complete control. That sets up a rematch today with the Auburn Tigers. It was ugly. It was ugly back on the plains in mid-February. And last night, or yesterday afternoon, talking with the media after the Arkansas game, Lamont Paris talked about things to improve on from the first Auburn game. Here's what he had to say.
Yeah, I mean, we sat down and watched the film. There were a lot of things, you know. I almost threw the film out just because it was an anomaly in the way that they performed as shooters. I mean, they had, I think, 9 made threes out of their 4 and their 5, right? And so – and they weren't just stare down threes that we saw. There wasn't a whole lot. I didn't yell at the guys. I don't think it was from lack of effort. I think they outplayed us. So it was, you know, at their place, it may have been an uphill battle either way, but they outplayed us. But then they shot the ball incredibly well. So it turned out to what it was. But so we just gotta. We'll go back. There's nothing I'm gonna do. There aren't enough fixes to not lose by 40, to go from losing by 40 to winning the game. There aren't that many things. So we got to do what we normally do, play our way, defend at a high level, finish plays off with a rebound, and then be aggressive on the offensive end. You know, hopefully we'll just play better. And to some degree, hopefully they won't shoot the ball like that. That would be some real bad karma if they could do that twice in a row against us.
Yeah, if they shoot that well twice, that's real bad. Real bad. There is a slight master of the understatement that Lamont Paris is subtly mastering when he says something like that. Yes, that would be bad karma if Auburn shoots 60% again from the field, from the three-point range. I think they're 90% from the foul line. Joining us now.
I probably would have just said that would suck, but he's so good at just being very eloquent about things.
I love how he worded that. Bad karma. Joining us now from Nashville, a man who has helped pack Jerry Stackhouse's gear already up. He called it yesterday. He wanted to make sure he was right, and Jerry Stackhouse relieved yesterday. But Elijah, the big thing yesterday was the 80-66 victory over South Carolina. Mm-hmm. How did you, being in the building, because those things are odd. It didn't look on television like there was a monstrous crowd. It didn't look all that packed. Arkansas had already played a game the day prior. South Carolina was making their first appearance there. Give me a little bit of a breakdown of the vibe and how that game played out with in terms of the atmosphere in that arena.
Yeah, in terms of atmosphere, I mean, it's probably one of the more true neutral court, or I guess neutral floor games that we're going to get. in this setting because, you know, like I said earlier in the week, Tennessee's going to bring a ton of people. Kentucky brings a ton of people every year. And there's always, regardless of who's playing, a ton of orange and blue in that arena. But I would even say Arkansas probably had a bigger showing, I guess, of fan support in that game. They brought a lot. Arkansas, to their credit, traveled really well. And that says a lot about how what they think about basketball, considering how poor that team has been this season. But throughout the game, you know, it was a that first half when Trevin Brazil hit a couple threes, Arkansas was able to get a lot of stuff going. There's a little bit of momentum in terms of the vibe of the game and the flow of the game. It felt like Arkansas was going to be able to hang in there. I do think there was a little bit of an element of tired legs, or, you know, maybe a like to quote the great Nick Van Exel, some Cancun on three attitude for Arkansas maybe in the last 5 minutes of that game. But for the most part, it was a good neutral floor. It was a, you know, for a 2:30 local tip on a Thursday afternoon, a pretty solid showing. And I think South Carolina was impressive enough on a lot of facets of the game that even the neutral observer was able to get some good basketball yesterday.
Let me say this. I've been to Nashville for an SEC basketball tournament previously. I believe it was during the Darren Horn era. I think South Carolina lost to Alabama. They had a huge lead. I believe it was Devin Downey's senior year, and South Carolina Houston lost a huge lead. The SEC has locked in the conference tournament at Bridgestone Arena up there through 2035. So they're locked in. That's where it is.
They ain't going anywhere.
I love that. I think I love that, you know, it's the South Carolina and Atlanta, the SEC and Atlanta are synonymous with each other for the SEC championship game. You know where it's at. I hope that this is the same type of deal with Nashville because, number one, that's a true, even though it's home of the Nashville Predators, that's a true arena. It's a basketball venue unlike what they used to do in Atlanta with the Georgia Dome, Elijah. That is a great environment up there, and you talk about it. South Carolina fans need to play and look every year. Go up there and be a part of it because I will say if you've never been to an SEC basketball tournament where you get all the fan bases together, obviously Nashville's fun, expensive, wildly expensive, but Nashville's a great town. Plan to go to these things here in the coming years because, Elijah, you can talk about the vibe outside of the arena, inside of the arena. It's only going to pick up with Kentucky and Tennessee taking the court today.
Oh, absolutely. I highly suggest for anybody, even if you're a South Carolina fan or a fan of any SEC school, or you just love basketball, it's such a cool event. And especially for, you know, the Wednesday and Thursday night games, usually tickets aren't too bad in terms of affordability. I mean, I obviously being from here, I know a lot of people here and the people I'm staying with, a couple of friends and my brother went to the games last night, the night session. They were able to buy like tickets to the night session at the last minute. They were able to come to the game. They say they love doing that almost every year because it's always really good basketball. And you can catch, you know, teams like Ole Miss and Texas A&M playing for relatively cheap. And it's always a really cool environment, just being able to walk through Broadway and see a ton of different shirts and try to count, you know, how many you see of a certain school. And it's always a blast, you know, and it's every year, I think Nashville's always done a really good job, even in the really weird COVID year, because that was the first year I covered the bit was 2021 season. And there was limited capacity in the building, but it still had a really great feel to it for every session of every day. And I highly recommend it for anybody who just loves basketball or is a fan, even at SEC team, no matter how good it is, you can come here and still have fun. I mean, there's even the Georgia contingency that came here yesterday. A lot of Georgia fans traveled and they were all over Broadway, and Nashville just does a really good job of putting it on. I think it's a solid central enough location, and there's just so much to do around here. You're right. It is getting expensive. You're getting more expensive than it already has been. But I highly recommend to anybody, if you're just a fan of basketball or the SEC, you have to do this at least once.
Let's transition back to yesterday's game. And yeah, you're right. By the way, again, I highly encourage it. This was a year I really kind of wanted to go, and it kind of didn't work out. St. Patrick's in Nashville plus an SEC basketball tournament, I feel like, is It's a combination that you need to be at, and over the next 10 years, we'll get it again. I'm with him. And if as long as this team especially continues to play and show up at this tournament with the amount of talent and the ability to win the tournament as they do, South Carolina fans need to make this a rite of passage for the spring to get up to Nashville and participate and cheer on the Gamecocks in this tournament. Let's talk about Arkansas just a second. You nailed it. You nailed it yesterday morning. You were basically just waiting on Jerry Stackhouse to be relieved of his job duties. Like I said, you may have even gone over and nudged a few people in that direction to be right. What was the vibe like, Eric Musselman in Arkansas? Because there's been a lot of stuff with that team this year. Musselman's an interesting guy. I mean, he is an odd guy to begin with, and a lot of rumors already about him potentially leaving. What did you take away from Arkansas yesterday after that loss, where they're at mentally and maybe the future of that program?
I think it's one of those things where they're glad the season's over. It's been such a mess from the beginning. Whether it be, a source I talked to yesterday who covers Arkansas said they had some eligibility problems in terms of academics. And, it's not frequently now in 2024 that we're talking about academic eligibility hindering some teams. But for Arkansas, they had about two or three rotation players at the beginning of the year have a hard time making good enough grades to get on the basketball floor. And so they had a lot of issues with that. So, there were some very odd rumors started by a Missouri message board later on in the season that came about. There's a lot of weirdness at this Arkansas basketball team and a lot of dysfunction. You had the Mekhi Mitchell incident at LSU earlier this year where Eric Musselman didn't think he was getting back hard enough on defense. And Mitchell disagreed pretty adamantly enough to get into coach's face, and they had to be separated. And yesterday, it really got to the point when South Carolina got that double-digit lead, when Arkansas made one last push to get down to six. But after a few buckets after that, they go on another little run, and I think that broke the Hogs after that. And it's hard to get a read on the Musselman situation because he's in a good position right now. And he's a hard guy to read because he always is so just high-strung on the sidelines. He's always really animated. The guy always has a ton of energy, and it resulted in a tech yesterday too. He did get hit with a tee at one point in the game because of that energy. But I don't know exactly if the Louisville job is a significant upgrade right now. If you're in the SEC, you have unlimited resources. You are also in a market that is basketball crazy. Fayetteville is a good basketball town, not to the extent that Louisville is, but You still have an athletic department that would do what it takes to get you to succeed as the basketball coach there. I don't know how much of an upgrade it is for Musselman to take that job, but with the way things are going this year, it wouldn't maybe be a shock to see him get a new change of scenery. Eric Musselman is a rolling stone. That man has gathered no moss. He has played, he's coached at a whole bunch of different spots, and usually not longer than 5 or 6 years. So maybe we might be hitting that 5 or 6 year Eric Musselman, timeline. So I wouldn't be surprised if Louisville reached out, and I wouldn't be surprised if Musselman took the call and didn't hesitate to go.
It's going to be another one. Obviously, yesterday we mentioned Vanderbilt, Oklahoma State opening up yesterday with former Gamecock Mike Boyd and a few others popping open as well. We'll kind of continue to monitor that. One thing that is known, South Carolina does not have to worry about losing Lamont Paris. They appear to have locked him in, and we'll get a little bit more from Elijah Campbell on that and look ahead to this Auburn game today. Auburn takes the floor for the first time later on. Tennessee and Mississippi State will get the morning, or I should say the afternoon, going at about 1 o'clock Eastern time, 12 Central, with a game there. Mississippi State winning yesterday may have secured them a place in the NCAA tournament. So we'll talk more about this. Elijah Campbell joining us live from Nashville at their Bridgestone Arena. Where, again, I believe he now has a new bunkmate. Jerry Stackhouse has moved in into his hotel room to save a little money. We'll talk with Elijah more about the SEC tournament against South Carolina Auburn today. You're listening to The Early Game.
Game Network.
The home of the Gamecocks. 107.5, The Game in Columbia. 100.5, The Game in Florence. 100.3, The Game in Myrtle Beach.
Also on the 107.5 The Game app and streaming live on The Game TV. Gotta take.
Hit us up on the Firehouse.
Firehouse Subs text line.
Firehouse Subs, founded by firemen.
803-404-6100.
On your home of the Gamecocks.
107.5 The Game.
Boy, we are March 15th. It is officially well past saying the new year. We are fully into 2024. But that doesn't mean that you aren't thinking about new things, such as maybe a new home, maybe thinking about building. This is the year you're ready to make that big move and upgrade the household. Family's getting bigger, and now you got to figure out how to do it. Well, guess what? First Palmetto Bank and the mortgage guru, Jacob Crowder, are ready to help you. That's right. They can find the interest rate or the loan that best fits your needs. Call today for a free consultation to learn what Jacob can do for you, what kind of interest rates, what kind of deal First Palmetto Bank can do. 803-719-1005. Again, that's 803-719-1005. First Palmetto Bank is locally owned and operated right here in the Midlands. They have quick and precise underwriting to get the answers you need in a timely fashion. So call the mortgage bureau today, 803-719-1005. Tell them you heard it with Bill Gunner on 107.5 The Game.
The Game.
Broadcasting live from the Herndon Chevrolet Studios.
Discover Herndon Certified. Herndon Chevrolet's premier used car warranty. Shop with complete confidence, knowing Herndon Chevrolet has got you covered.
Stop by or shop online today and see why Herndon Chevrolet makes you smile.
There's something remarkable about the University of South Carolina. It's in the labs, where researchers are discovering ways to make communities healthier and stronger. It's in the nation's best first-year student experience, in top-ranked programs in nursing and health sciences. It's where more South Carolina students have access to higher education than ever before. Because when you stand for something bigger than yourself, you could create something that benefits us all. Behold, the remarkable we.
West Texas Tech entitled with approved credit, call 866-243-4623 for details. We interrupt this broadcast with an important news alert. There's a slasher on the loose. JT's Chrysler Jeep Dodge Ram is slashing prices. New Rams were $12,000 off, slashed to $14,000 off. New Jeeps were $10,000 off, slashed to $12,000 off. This just in, new Chargers and Challengers slashed $10,000 off. Now here's the weather. Whether or not your credit is cloudy, JT sees sunny days ahead. Nobody fights harder to get you approved. JT's Chrysler Jeep Dodge Ram, Greystone Boulevard and 378 Lexington. Jeep celebrates. Event.
March into serenity and step into relaxation with the Spring Madness Member for a Day sale at Hand in Stone Massage and Facial Spa. Indulge in exclusive benefits, including 10% off products, access to low member price services, and special savings on gift cards. Explore rejuvenation at their locations in the Columbia area or visit handinstone.com to unlock online offers. Embrace the tranquil spirit of spring. See spa for details. Restrictions may apply.
Powered by Integrated Media, The Game TV.
Sponsored by Shepherd's Glass, a true reflection of quality.
The Game TV.
Sponsored by Shepherd's Glass.
Music fans, on Friday, March 22nd, a very special night is coming to Columbia. Southern Songwriters with Patrick Davis, a national television show produced for SCE-TV and American Public Television, is taping live at the historic Chappelle Auditorium at Allen University. Patrick will be joined by Drew Holcomb, David Ryan Harris, and Sean Mullins. This show will air on more than 300 stations this summer, and you can be part of it. Tickets are on sale at SouthernSongwriters.com or PatrickDavisMusic.com. One night only, March 22nd in Columbia.
Hey, Gamecocks. Ben Cato. Cold weather is here now, and if you're like me, that probably means you haven't touched your yard equipment in a while. Don't wait until the weeds are knee-high. The service center at Cato's Power Equipment is here to fix any problem, big or small. Let us keep your tools one pull away from getting you back to work. Mention this ad, and we'll throw in a free oil change and fuel flush on any Toro, Gravely, or Aaron Zero Turn, now through March 31st. Only at Cato's Power Equipment, 4012 West Beltline Boulevard, right outside of downtown Columbia.
JT's Kia Mania is back, and we're giving away two brand new Kias. Be there this Saturday at 5 p.m. No purchase necessary. Just come in and register your location. JT's Kia, Greystone Boulevard or Killian Road. Don't miss this giveaway.
WIS-TV First Alert Traffic
is sponsored by Wetzel's Automotive in West Columbia. Wetzelsauto.com.
You're working that earlier. Let's try again. Take two. Earlier tie up I-26 eastbound at exit 91. Report there of an accident. Also I-77 southbound at Forest Drive. And in Lexington, Old Cherokee Road at Old Chapin Road. And we're not looking for any rain until maybe tonight. Overall, the high today of 80. Some afternoon sun tomorrow, 78 for the high, 73 on Sunday. Right now, it's 57 on the early game.
Early game with Bill Gunter,
former Gamecock Preston Thorne,
and Jen Jensen, your home of the Gamecocks in Columbia, 107.5 The Game.
Also heard on 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach and 100.5 The Game in Florence.
Elijah Campbell joining us from Nashville, the men's SEC tournament, sponsored by Cool Care Heating and Air, Plumbing and Refrigeration. Thank you to Cool Care Heating and Air, Plumbing and Refrigeration for getting Elijah up there safely where he can overindulge in Sunkist and Dr. Pepper. When I was in Nashville back in the summer, Elijah, they had all kinds. I think they even had a strawberries and cream Dr. Pepper. Do they have the big Dr. Pepper machine? With just cans upon cans upon cans of Dr. Pepper.
Oh, if you are a Dr. Pepper fan, the media hospitality area would be your version of heaven, right? Like it's everywhere. There's so much Dr. Pepper here. It is not even funny. I feel like Forrest Gump wanting to drink it all at the same time and then having to go pee early on in the game. Because it's just free. You want to take advantage of it. But all the Sunkist and Dr. Pepper you could possibly want.
I'm not offending you, hopefully, but I can promise you, many of you out there, if you think that the media people are dorks that try to get all the free items they can, you are 100% right, because I participated in that back at SEC Media Day. You don't even know what to do with it. You feel like you should just take cans upon cans of Dr. Pepper back to your hotel room and bring them home, because you never know when you're going to be around that much again. And usually they have some kind of odd off-brand bag of chips you can grab as well.
In the press box during the football season, that's Terry Ford with the bags of snacks, the popcorn.
Popcorn.
Yep. I mean, he comes out of there looking like he's gained 40 pounds just because his pockets are full.
Yeah, I can tell you this. If whatever you think out there about media members in hospitality rooms,
you're not wrong.
You're probably even underestimating it.
Well, it's not like anybody in the media is really paid terribly well, you know, in most cases. So we have to make up for it, right?
Nor are most of the media members extremely fit, because they're in cars. I went through that day where you drive around, you're just stopping for bags of M&Ms and Mountain Dews, and there is not a doctor out there that goes, yeah, that's a good strategy. Bags of M&Ms or Reese's Pieces and Mountain Dews when you're traveling from venue to venue. Speaking of putting all these people in a room, this is where it's interesting. What was the reaction yesterday, Elijah? As news is coming out, as tweets are coming out about this extension for Lamont Paris, maybe the financial, we're going to learn more this morning, but hearing other media members from other schools, other programs, this reaction as it was kind of circulating that South Carolina has locked in Lamont Paris.
Yeah, I think their reaction and kind of the vibe around it is kind of a good reflection as to how remarkable the turnaround was. It was kind of a sense of, hey, good for you, because you have a really good basketball team that's cracked the top 15, you know, for the first time in Lord knows how long. You've had a remarkable year, a very memorable season. You're going to the NCAA tournament as a 5 seed. You're a team that here in Nashville, none of these teams here want to play, because they play you. It can be torturous with your style of play. And it's a feeling of good for those guys. In a way, you know, you had your guy, you got him locked in. It's going to be an incredibly crazy coaching carousel here in the next several weeks with teams that might bow out of the NCAA tournament earlier, or, you know, in Mike Boynton and Jerry Stackhouse's case, at Vandy and Oklahoma State, don't make it at all. There's already been a ton of spots open up, and Ohio State was still kind of dangling there. And, you know, I know there was interest, you know, like that was Lamont Paris was a name that was being, you know, potentially looked at. and to be able to take Lamont off the table, I feel like the consensus around the SEC is that was the right thing for the Gamecocks to do, for Ray Tanner to do. And, you know, I walked into the arena yesterday at the same time as Ray Tanner. He had a glow. There's a glow to him. He seemed to be in a pretty good mood. And, you know, if I would have extended my head coach that is the SEC coach of the year and got us into the NCAA tournament for the first time in, I don't know, math is hard, 7 years, you know, I think I would be in a similar mood. So I think that the general consensus is that South Carolina did the right thing. And, you know, maybe them being a top five seed in this tournament, you know, from here till 2035 is not going to be an anomaly anymore.
It is. The last time I remember seeing this much positive publicity for South Carolina was coming off of the court at Madison Square Garden after beating Florida in the Elite Eight. But that was just positive publicity. This feels different. This feels like a lot of people are taking notice, and we'll see if it comes to fruition. I'm doing that thing this morning. We're overhyping, and now we have to wait to see if it lives up to the hype. But it feels, reading Twitter yesterday, or X, whatever we want to call it, reading social media sites, reading articles, that South Carolina has given itself a chance to be relevant in the college basketball world moving forward with Lamont Paris. And the more people are meeting him, the more people are talking to him, doing interviews, they're realizing who this guy is. And the enjoyment of wanting to interview him is growing, not just by the local media. We love having him in here. I don't think he fits our program for X's and O's. That's not what Preston and I like to talk. We like to talk about mac and cheese and washing cars and all those things with him. And we'll get him back on in the month of April. But people are loving talking to him. It's interesting to see South Carolina basketball a year removed, 1 year removed from where they were and how the attitude is up there, how the attitude is up there in Nashville. Now, today, I've called it a no-lose situation. Elijah, I think South Carolina's in a great place. They've secured no worse than a five seed, in my opinion. It would be crazy. It could happen. You never know. It's a committee. But if South Carolina wasn't at least a five seed, a win today, maybe they move up. Maybe they move up a line to a four seed. If you lose, I think you take whatever you learn. You come back home and you get rested up for playing either next Thursday or Friday.
Yeah, I mean, this is the term, you know, I think we use it pretty loosely sometimes. You know, playing with house money can be overused, but I genuinely think they are right now. Even with a win today, I don't know even if it jumps you in to the four spot. You know, looking at Lenardi's bracketology earlier in the week, you look at some of the teams that are on the four line, you know, BYU maybe, but they've got like at least three more quad one wins, and including one at Fog Allen Fieldhouse. And if you want to know a mind-numbing stat, Bill Self has a better win percentage at Kansas for home games in his career there than Steph Curry has career free throw percentage. It is more rare that, you know, Bill Self loses at home than Steph Curry misses a free throw. So that win's going to take BYU a long way, even with some of the losses that they've suffered in Big 12 play. And Kansas themselves also on the four line. They got throttled by Cincinnati, but I think the NCAA tournament committee is going to take into account that they were without their two best players in that game too. I think there's been an emphasis on winning away from home, and there's been an emphasis on taking into context your personnel in the games that you win or lose. So I do feel like they are pretty solidified into this spot right now. It would be a fantastic momentum builder for this program to be able to beat a team that beat you by 40 just a month ago, and to be able to do it on ESPN on a stage like this, to be able to get yourself, you know, into the SEC semifinals and set up, you know, a round three with Tennessee, it's pretty good. And, you know, even if you end up going to that semifinal game or even the championship game, you pull off an upset, or, you know, you end up playing Mississippi State, because, I mean, Mississippi State beat Tennessee earlier in the year. That's not impossible that the Bulldogs come out with a win. They're really desperate right now. So it's not completely out of the realm of possibility that you see them if you make it past Auburn. So a run to the SEC championship game, depending on how it looks like, might move you up into a four. You could maybe leapfrog BYU, but right now you still got to like the spot that you're in. The 5-12 game can be pretty tricky at times, and that could be a trap that a lot of high majors fall into in the tournament year after year. But I feel like for the most part, they can play as loose as possible because the expectation here is that they're not going to win the game. They'll keep it close, but the expectation is kind of that they're not going to win the game. And the expectation is for their tournament seeding is that they're in the land of the Lux and they're possibly in the land of the Lux for the five seed, you know, a subset of that land of Lux category. So I think that will actually end up showing early on in the game exactly how loose and how free they're able to play.
Elijah, we appreciate it. I know you got another busy day up there. The big fan base has come rolling in Kentucky and Tennessee. Try not to get caught up on Broad Street. Maybe Kid Rock's bar today. It's I've been there. Expensive is an understatement, but it's fun. You focus on work. I'll focus on the fun part.
Hey, that's right. Now, I might just say to Martin's Barbecue today. It's right down the road from
Bridgestone. Good.
It's a little further from Broadway. The barbecue's really good. I might go for round two this week.
Go get it, buddy. We'll holler at you on Monday morning.
Sounds good. See you guys.
Elijah Campbell, again, live from Nashville. Thank you again to Cool Care Heating and Air Plumbing and Refrigeration for having him up there. We'll come back. We'll wrap up a few other things. It's the Early Game.
The Game Network.
The home of the Gamecocks. 107.5, The Game in Columbia. 100.5, The Game in Florence. 100.3, The Game in Myrtle Beach.
Also on the 107.5, The Game app. And streaming live on The Game TV. The game will be at the beach, in the PD.
Retail storefronts, auto, custom shower enclosures and mirrors for that remodeling or new construction project. Visit shepherdsglass.com to see and learn more. Now with two locations on Flat Springs Road in West Columbia and Chapin at 855 Chapin Road. shepherdsglass.com.
Shepherd's Glass. Shepherd's Glass, a true reflection of quality.
The Carolina Cup races are Saturday, March 30th, presented by MUSC Health. The 89th running on the Springdale Racecourse, a pristine setting on green grass, beautiful pines under blue skies in Camden, South Carolina. Nothing rivals this great Southern tradition in steeplechase racing. The family fun event you do not want to miss. Incredible tailgating, shopping, food, and unique entertainment for everyone, including the True Vista Kit Zone. Get your tickets now at carolinacup.org. March 30th, rain or shine. The Midland's Best St. Paddy's Festival is happening at O'Hara's Public House in Lexington, and you're cordially invited to share in the celebration March 16th and 17th. St. Paddy's Day weekend starts at O'Hara's Bakery at 8 a.m. both Saturday and Sunday, with kegs and eggs at the pub starting at 9. Food and drink specials are happening all day, both inside the pub and outside under the party tent. Make sure you get in for your serving of corned beef and cabbage or any of the traditional Irish favorites available year-round at O'Hara's Public House. Starting at 3 p.m. on Sunday, come out to enjoy two of Columbia's favorite musical acts as they come together to rock the outside stage under the big top with Prettier Than Matt and Tokyo Joe. That's Saturday and Sunday, the 16th and 17th at O'Hara's Pub and Bakery. It's our sweet deal of the week. Get $50 towards your next visit to O'Hara's Public House for just $25. This Friday at 9 a.m., log on to 1075thegame.com and click on Sweet Deals to get your $50 to O'Hara's Public House for just $25.
Paris.
JT's Kia Mania is back, and we're giving away two brand new Kias. Be there this Saturday at 5 p.m. No purchase necessary. Just come in and register at either location. JT's Kia, Greystone Boulevard, or Killian Road. Don't miss this giveaway.
Hey, this is Jen Jensen for CHW Cabinetry. My family is using CHW Cabinetry, and they are fantastic to work with. They make sure you're satisfied with every step of the process. Not only do their photorealistic renderings show exactly what your new space will look like, their job site guarantees everyone is on the same page, literally. Experience the CHW difference for yourself. Go to chwcabinetry.com to see more or call them at 803-520-6837 and be sure to tell them Jen Jensen sent you. CHW Cabinetry, passion from inspiration to installation.
Nucor Buildings Group, based in Swansea, South Carolina, specializes in the sale, creation, and fabrication of pre-engineered steel buildings tailored for a diverse range of purposes, including applications such as warehousing, churches, airplane hangars, sports facilities, and more.
Nucor has just been named to Barron's prestigious 100 Most Sustainable U.S. Companies 2024 list.
Notably, Nucor is the only steel company to be included on the list.
This recognition is a testament to their unyielding commitment to sustainability and the culture of teamwork and innovation that energizes their pursuits.
Go to Nucor.com/careers and search Swansea.
Hit us up on the Firehouse Subs text line, 803-404-6100.
Your home of the Gamecocks in Columbia, 107.5 The Game. Also heard on 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach and 100.5 The Game in Florence.
WIS-TV First Alert Traffic is sponsored by Wetzel's Automotive in West Columbia. Wetzelsauto.com.
A few more accidents out there to make you aware of. I-26 eastbound there at exit 91. Still an accident there that they're working on. Also a tie-up I-77 southbound at Forest Drive. Old Cherokee Road at Old Chapin. And aside from that, I guess another one dropped off, so good. We're getting accidents cleared up as we speak. But as far as your forecast goes, we're looking for a high today of about 80. Some evening storms could be coming our way. 78 for the high tomorrow, 73 on Sunday, and actually 66 by Monday. But we're warming up a little bit, 57 on the early game.
You're talking about. Sponsored by Love Chevrolet.
On your home of the Gamecocks. In Columbia, 107.5 The Game.
Also heard on 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach. And 100.5 The Game in Florence.
Thank you to Elijah Campbell for joining us again. And thank you to Cool Care Heating and Air, Plumbing and Refrigeration for sponsoring Elijah being in Nashville this week for the SEC men's basketball tournament. A lot of good coverage. It is interesting. I've been to some of these, and you go into that back room. It is funny, Jen, because unlike SEC Media Day, where there's so much going on, maybe you're trying to get quotes from other players, other coaches, even if they're not your team. Yeah, a lot of the media members, like from other teams that might be playing, just congregate in the hospitality area, and they'll have a breakfast, they'll have a lunch, they'll have a dinner, and then they'll have snacks in between, and all mm-hmm. the Dr. Pepper you can drink. It's like, yeah, it is like Forrest Gump at the White House.
It's almost like you've never seen snacks before. Oh. You know, and maybe it's just because it's your house, you find something in the cabinet or something, but at these things, they're, you know, it's this display or these baskets of all these goodies, and you're rumbling through to find out, you know, oh my gosh, there's a Rice Krispie treat, and yes. Oh my gosh, there's something chocolate in there, and then I've actually heard a couple of people in the press box say, what are these nuts? Like, what is this? This is like health food.
Yeah, normally there's a huge like a wire bowl of fruit that is completely untouched.
Yeah.
At those things, mm-hmm. But you hear interesting stuff. You know, you talk with other reporters, you talk with others, some of the national writers are there. And maybe, again, they don't want to watch the particular game that's taking place at that moment. Maybe the game gets out of hand. They walk back there and you hear a lot of stuff. And it is interesting to hear the background right now on some of the things with Arkansas, with Vanderbilt, what may be going on at Texas A&M, who's not particularly thrilled with Buzz Williams right now and obviously has a new athletic director. But we thank Cool
Cool Care Heating and Air, Plumbing and Refrigeration for having Elijah up there to be on the scene and relay some of that information.
He does a good job up there. He really does.
Well, Nashville's, you got to go somewhere.
Yeah, he's...
Especially on company dime.
Mm-hmm. And I think he's actually saving the company some money because he's staying with some friends. So
then he's...
So they're like, yeah, here you go. It's
a complete winning situation up there. Martin's Barbecue is a good call for him as well.
Let's go run up and get some for us. Bring it back.
7 hours. That's a drive. I'll check what Southwest is doing with flights. Mm. A couple of y'all have asked, as this pertains now to this contract extension, Michael saying, I'm not sure when the signing period is for basketball, but is there still time for recruits to commit for 2024, 2025? And do you see that happening because of the extension? No, there's really South Carolina's class. Now, let's remember, at this point in time, South Carolina only has three spots to give away. Now, it's what we know. There will be, I'm sure, there will be a defection or two. It'll probably end up closer to five when it's said and done. But you only have three players who are completely out of eligibility. Benjamin Bosman Verdonk is the one that I'm not 100% sure on that could be the fourth, but it's my understanding he actually does have another year of eligibility. The three that I am aware of is BJ Mack, Talon Cooper, and Stephen Clark. Those were the ones honored on senior night a week ago during the Tennessee game. So with all that being said, South Carolina does only have three spots to give, and they already have two guys who are committed to the program in Trent Noah and I believe we're calling him Jamie Shaw's got his name down better, and he actually has it down to a simpler name, but I believe it's Oki Federico is who we're going to go with. I believe, again, Jamie Shaw's come up with a different name for him there. So South Carolina already has two guys committed as it pertains to this upcoming class, which, again, just doing the numbers, just doing the raw numbers and what we believe, that would only leave one spot left. And South Carolina is going to need, I think, to sign an experienced point guard. Talon Cooper has made such an impact this year with his ability to handle the ball, with his ability to make things happen. I think it's going to be important to bring in another point guard to kind of help out in that position, and we'll see how that works out. Just for the record, the spring signing period, if there was a recruit that were to pop up, if there was a recruit that were to pop up, it would actually be April 17th through May 15th. You got a whole signing area there that somebody can sign. So it's April 17th through May 15th is when the spring signing period does open. But again, unless something happens, there is, I think, one thing you keep a small eye on just because of the success of South Carolina this year and because of the success of him as a high school recruit is current 2025 recruit Eli Ellis, who's playing for Overtime Elite, who's obviously been a guy that has drawn a lot of attention social media-wise, but also by the way he has played. It is possible he is eligible. He is eligible, if he so chose to do so, to enroll early, and that maybe is one you keep an eye on, and then maybe South Carolina hits the transfer portal. But again, you look at what South Carolina's got right now, as far as we know, coming back again, what does Michi Johnson do? Does he feel he is ready for the NBA? Miles Studi, technically, with another year of eligibility as well. Josh Gray as well. You get the point. So what does Michi Johnson do? But at this point in time, I don't think that this contract impacts this current recruiting class. What I do think it helps with is the 2025-2026 recruiting class. Think about that. Just mentioning that far out, 2025, 2026, but basically the rising junior or the current juniors, guys like Isaiah Henry, who South Carolina hosted on an official visit a few weeks ago. He would fill the class with Eli Ellis, with Hayden Simeon, I believe is how you say his name, from Powdersville. So you get the point. This will help moving forward. It will help capitalize when Lamont Paris goes out into the travel basketball circuit starting in late April and into July and is looking at prospects and trying to create a bigger board to move forward with. That's what I would anticipate there. So not much to keep an eye on. Well, again, we'll learn. I think it'll be more of a transfer portal offseason for Coach Paris to fill out the roster for next year to go along with the two recruits he already has coming in. 803-404-6100. We'll wrap it up. A little bit of baseball tonight. Have not mentioned that. Let you hear just a little bit from Mark Kingston and get into South Carolina and Mississippi. And we'll take a final look at today's third round game against Auburn. The Gamecocks looking to avenge that loss back in February. And you know what? It's a no-lose situation. They're in a great place. They're in an absolutely great place. We'll finish that up as well. You're listening to Bill Gunner, Jen Jensen. It is the early game.
The Game Network.
The home of the Gamecocks. 107.5, the game in Columbia.
100.5, the game in Florence.
100.3, the game in Myrtle Beach.
Also on the 107.5, the game app. And streaming live on the Game TV. Powered by Integrated Media, the Game TV.
Sponsored by Shepherd's Glass, a true reflection of quality.
The Game TV.
Bill Gunner for Mid-State Roofing. You've heard me mention it. Looking outside, a little overcast right now. Rain expected on the way. So is your roof ready to handle any rain? Are you going to have any leaks, or have you already done leak detection? Well, if you haven't, it's time to call Mid-State Roofing in their 24-hour-a-day, 7-day-a-week call center. You'll speak with an on-call technician. Doesn't matter what time you call. Somebody is there to help you. That is the kind of service that Mid-State Roofing has provided. They'll advise you. They'll give you proper advice. Again, they'll have incredible service, and those results will be the kind of things you need to keep your facility in a manner both safe and pleasing to your operation. So call Mid-State Roofing today. Get a maintenance contract, 803-356-1919. Again, that's 803-356-1919. You can visit them on the web for more information, midstateroofing.com. Don't wait another day. We got summer thunderstorms on the way. If you've got a leak, let Mid-State Roofing take a peek.
I'm Bart Winkler with a CBS Sports Minute, sponsored by LL Flooring. LL Flooring, every step covered. You can't win the Super Bowl during the first week of free agency, but you can position yourself to get much closer. That's exactly what the Houston Texans have done. Sure, the AFC is loaded with great quarterbacks, but how far really is the gap between them and CJ Stroud? Joe Mixon is an upgrade in the backfield. Danielle Hunter has a lot of good football left. If you want a sleeper pick in the AFC, pick the Houston Texans now before they become one of the favorites. I'm Bart Winkler. CBS Sports Radio.
If you're a pro and flooring is your game, we'll help you win it. Because at LL Flooring, all we do is floors. You want decor?
Try.
You want plumbing?
Yeah.
LL Flooring has been helping pros knock it out of the park for over 30 years. Visit one of our 400 nationwide warehouses for one-on-one service, extensive inventory, and exclusive pro pricing.
Oh, run.
Get the pro treatment you deserve. Enroll today, online or in-store. LL Flooring, every step covered.
The Omaha Steaks semi-annual sale is here. Get 50% off site-wide and save on mouth-watering favorites today. Go to omahasteaks.com and shop the semi-annual sale where you can load up on all the delicious flavor you crave at half the price. And when you use promo code SIZZLE at checkout, you'll get an extra $30 off your order. Save big on delicious, tender, juicy steaks, big, beefy burgers, and so much more. That's omahasteaks.com, promo code SIZZLE at checkout. Minimum purchase may apply.
Omaha Steaks, America's original butcher.
Music fans, on Friday, March 22nd, a very special night is coming to Columbia. Southern Songwriters with Patrick Davis, a national television show produced for SCE TV and American Public Television, is taping live at the historic Chappelle Auditorium at Allen University. Patrick will be joined by Drew Holcomb, David Ryan Harris, and Sean Mullins. This show will air on more than 300 stations this summer, and you can be part of it. Tickets are on sale at SouthernSongwriters.com or PatrickDavisMusic.com. One night only, March 22nd in Columbia.
Honey, would you take a seat? I have a confession to make.
What is it? What's wrong?
Well, I was out driving today and I saw some hookers on the side of the road. A bunch of huge, professional, beautiful-looking hookers. So I did what I was supposed to do. I slowed down and I moved over.
You slowed down for the hookers?
Well, yeah, it's the law. There was a whole fleet of Schroeder's towing trucks assisting with an accident. Wait. What did you think I was talking about?
Schroeder's Towing reminds you to slow down and move over for all first responders.
Schroeder's Towing, the best and fastest hookers in town.
The early game.
With Bill Gunter, former Gamecock Preston Thorne, and Jen Jensen.
Your home of the Gamecocks in Columbia. 107.5, the game.
Also heard on 100.3, the game in Myrtle Beach.
And 100.5, the game in Florence.
South Carolina baseball set to take a three-game series to Swayze Field in Oxford, Mississippi. Gets going tonight, 7:30 Eastern time. First pitch, we'll have the pregame right here coming up at 7:15. But a reminder, go to 1075thegame.com and register for the Palmetto Citizens FCU Grand Slam giveaway. Every game that there is no home run hit, $25 is added to the pot. Right now, the pot is $450. If a Gamecock hitter gets a grand slam, you can win all of the cash in the pot. And again, right now, $450. You just need to go to 1075thegame.com and register for the Palmetto Citizens FCU Grand Slam giveaway, where every game, again, you have a chance to win. $450 is in the pot. And if a Gamecock hitter rips a grand slam, you win all the cash in the pot. So again, go to 1075thegame.com and register for the Palmetto Citizens FCU Grand Slam giveaway. Again, the Gamecocks taking on Mississippi this weekend. Ole Miss entering with a 13-5 overall record for them. They're bouncing back a little bit. South Carolina does lead the all-time series 39-28. The two teams last met in 2022 in Columbia. South Carolina took 2 of 3 in that particular series. The last time South Carolina went to Oxford, they were swept by Ole Miss. So we'll see how they perform this weekend as SEC play gets going across the league. By the way, I don't quite understand how this is working out. I don't know who does not like South Carolina in the SEC, but the Gamecocks will open SEC play on the road for the fourth straight season. Last year, they were on the road at Georgia, the year prior at Tennessee, and in 2021 at Vanderbilt. So four straight seasons for South Carolina of opening SEC play on the road. So where is this team right now? How are they performing? Well, that's what Mark Kingston has talked a little bit about this week. Right now, one thing that you can talk about is South Carolina's pitching staff performing very well. Second in both the SEC and the NCAA with a 2.21 ERA after 17 games. Very pleased there. That's something you're very happy about. The hitting, well, took a step forward over last weekend, but how's it going to do against SEC pitching this coming weekend for Mississippi? Again, we'll see. Gunnar Dennis will be on the mound. He's one of their top pitchers, and he will get the start tonight. 3-0 in the season, 4.34 ERA. He's pitched 18 and two-thirds innings, 22 strikeouts, 9 walks. Eli Jones will get the call tonight for the Gamecocks. 2-0 in the season with a 1.40 ERA and 19 and a third innings, 17 strikeouts, just 2 walks for Eli Jones. Dylan Eskew on the mound tomorrow, 2-1 on the season with a 2.89 ERA and 18 and two-thirds pitch, 15 strikeouts, 6 walks for the Gamecocks. So the arms appear to be in good shape. It's the bats that will need to get going this coming weekend. For those of you wondering, by the way, tonight and Sunday are being streamed on SEC Network Plus. So you'll have to have the SEC Network Plus app. Tomorrow's game will be televised on the SEC Network. So you'll be able to see that there if you want to check out a bunch of action. Should be a fun game. You're able to watch basketball tonight, 3:30, and then flip over on the SEC Network Plus at 7:30. to catch South Carolina and Mississippi. Again, the series will be played tomorrow at 2 o'clock, Sunday at 2:30, both of those Eastern time for those of you interested in that. 803-404-6100, how you can weigh in if you so choose to do so. Our buddy Jan Bennett texting, he's on his way to Oxford. Be safe traveling there, Jan. Go out there and pull the Gamecocks through as they play a very important – you got to get off to a good start. Got to get on. I do think this team, I don't know where their confidence level is, but they do need to get off to a good start. We'll talk more about that as we get through. Again, Vanderbilt in town next weekend for South Carolina as they will open SEC play at home this weekend on the road, next weekend at Founders Park, and we'll talk a lot more about that next week leading up to the Vanderbilt series. But a lot of discussion has been around this basketball team. A great day. And there's just no other way to describe it. A great day yesterday for the University of South Carolina men's basketball program as a whole. You lock up the coach who has led you to the best regular season you've ever had. You lock up the guy who has now won an SEC tournament game. You lock up Lamont Paris for hopefully 6 years. We'll know more about these details. I will say one of the things about that you're looking for today
one of the things you're looking is what are the exact numbers when this board of trustees releases the contract information for Lamont Paris. Obviously, how much he is being paid is something that we'll look at, but what are the buyout numbers for that, both for Lamont Paris and for any school coming to try and poach Lamont Paris? That'll be another big number that we're looking at today. Just to give you an update, going into today, both Joe Lunardi with ESPN and Dr. Jerry Palm with CBS have updated their bracketologies. Both were updated this morning. And this is going into today's games across the board, not just South Carolina. Both Joe Lunardi and Jerry Palm have South Carolina as a 5 seed in Spokane, Washington. All right, so that's right now. Both guys projecting South Carolina to go to Spokane, Washington. Jerry Palm actually has South Carolina playing in the West Regional. Joe Lunardi has South Carolina playing in the Midwest Regional, but the way they do those things now, it's kind of awkward. But he has both guys are projecting South Carolina to be sent out to Washington. Joe Lunardi has South Carolina playing automatic qualifier McNeese, coached by one Will Wade. I'm not real thrilled about that. He has South Carolina projected as a potential second-round matchup against Kansas. Kansas would have a first-round matchup against VCU. South Carolina's path would also include a potential game against Purdue. That's the Joe Lunardi bracket. Jerry Palm has South Carolina, again, as a 5 seed, taking on VCU in Spokane. He's got Kansas as the 4 seed, playing would potentially be a second-round game for the Gamecocks, and he would have South Carolina having to go through number 1 seed, Tennessee in the West. So we'll see how that changes. But the Gamecocks in Auburn today, you can hear it right here on 107.5 The Game. We'll get the pregame started at 3 o'clock. It's going to be a fun day. It's going to be a great weekend. Hope all of y'all enjoy it. We'll see you on Monday. Bill Gunner for the Ecton Law Firm. That's right. Tax season is upon us. You're having to deal with those pesky taxes. Maybe you've already done it. And unfortunately, you've also received one of those dreaded notices of intent to levy against you or your business. And now that's causing stress. Don't let it cause you the stress. Go ahead. Enjoy this weekend. Enjoy 2024 by contacting the Ecton Law Firm and getting a free consultation today. 803-771-9800. Again, that's 803-771-9800. The Ecton Law Firm, they've got a local team dedicated to resolving your income or business tax issues for good. And that's important. You want to get these things taken care of. You don't want to be dealing with tax issues, especially this time of year. So call for a free consultation, 803-771-9800. For more information, visit them on the web, ectonlawfirm.com. That's ectonlawfirm.com. Call them today. Tell them Bill Gunner sent you.
Broadcasting live from the Herndon Chevrolet Studios, this is 107.5 The Game.
A great selection of new Chevys is available now at Herndon Chevrolet. The lot is packed with inventory and more is on the way. So shop your hometown Chevy dealer today.
Stop by or shop online today and see why Herndon Chevrolet makes you smile.
Breaks.
You want to know where we're supposed to park for this thing tomorrow?
No.
That was my biggest question.
Y'all have a great day. Great weekend. We'll see you.